I should have heed my own words.
Should have came in that guy.
Yeah, I shouldn't have came in that guy.
Fucking mama just killed
came in the guy. I mean, that's true as well for that song.
Yeah, I know. That was my point. You gave him AIDS is what I was saying.
Oh, I gave him AIDS?
Yeah.
I didn't touch buttholes with him.
Hey, everybody, and welcome to episode 201 of the Not For Human Consumption Podcast. Your update on all the things weekly, boy. I'm your host, Matt, bringing you week in and week out that sultry throat magic.
Is this for the start of October?
Yeah, it's the spooky month.
It's gonna be fucking Rocktober, dude.
It's gonna be Rocktober, brother. Rocktoberfest.
Yeah, I made my background for fall. The leaves are falling.
And with me, as always, is Dylan Bot Milk Troxel.
What the fuck?
You're the only person I know that signed a fucking goddamn.
Oh, yeah.
A goddamn.
For milk?
No!
I don't even know how.
A class action lawsuit to get a payment because he bought milk once.
I don't even know how that happened.
It was an expensive milk, too.
But I must have signed up for it randomly one time. Like, I must have got an email or something. Like, yeah, sure, whatever. I buy milk all the time. And then today they're like, here's $8.
Like, sick, dude. If you ever bought milk, here's your refund.
Dude, it was kind of like that. Like, have you bought milk ever?
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I have. They're like, all right, we'll try to get you some.
The fucking rebate literally says on their email, little screenshot, you just send the screenshot of you getting $8 back. And it said, all it says at the top in giant bold letters is bought milk. Like,
dude, I got.
I get it. It's the play on got milk.
Yeah.
Milk.
I didn't even put that together. Fuck.
I got like $40 from a class action lawsuit for Bumble.
Yeah.
Because but it was like them. Like, they were like, hey, we fucked up and we're sending everyone money.
We fucked up and there's a rash outbreak of fucking gonorrhea.
Oh, and how the fuck did you. What was the fuck up in the milk?
I don't know. I don't remember what it was for, but fucking, should I look it up and see what the fucking...
Yeah, look that up as I introduce the third and final host of this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Jay, ground-gripping businessman.
Are you okay? You made a face, right before you announced me,
no.
Something was going to reverse in your stomach.
No. Oh, wait, doing shots before the show started. Yeah. So I'm a little twisted. I'm a little fucking twisted, you know what I'm saying? But it's episode 201, the beginning of the spooky month. It's October 1st. Dylan is researching why he bought milk once.
Dylan Dairy Boy Trox.
Dylan the Dare Boy.
Old dairy boy.
Dairy to keep a kid off milk.
Oh,
I can't stand fucking milk, dude. Or drinking it. It's disgusting. I heard once they put goddamn syrup in it to make it to cover up the blood and pus.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, what happened?
The bought milk lawsuit was brought against dairy producers claiming price fixing. Businesses agreeing with one another to only sell products for a certain price, leading to higher out-of-pocket costs for buyers.
Motherfuckers.
In July of this year, the courts approved a $7.51 payout for individuals and $210 for businesses. Damn, if we would have had the LLC, man, I could have been like, the milk for the podcast was way too expensive. We are $210, and then we're in the fucking green.
Dylan. Hey, well, hey, all this will take place. Read the literature you have been given.
Yes. Jay has, he is ground-gripping businessman. We saw Jay in a whole new light. I've never seen him before in my life, and he's one of my oldest friends on the planet. But he sat Dylan and I down at a restaurant and slid paperwork across like we were applying for a loan. It was crazy.
While the loudest football game was in my ear.
He moved. Let it go, Dylan.
Yeah. We're going.
We moved tables just for you.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate it.
Yeah, that place Caps, the restaurant we went to, was fucking rad though. Like their wing sauce collection.
Dude, that ancho wing sauce was fucking phenomenal. Mm-hmm. That shit was so good.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Fucking who cares about any of this? Like, can we just talk about the thing that happened?
Oh, yeah, if you want to get in there, bro.
Because, like...
Are we allowed to?
Yeah, we're allowed
to. Dylan read the literature.
We just can't do the read, yeah?
Yeah.
We could talk about it. We just can't do, like, a testimonial about it because we don't have it yet.
Okay. So we all got married.
Yeah. It's a domestic partnership, kind of, though. Mm-hmm.
Listen.
It's a guyfecta.
First off...
Guyfecta? That's why I got that throat magic. Okay, go ahead, Dylan. Mm-hmm.
Offhand comment to Walter to try to, because he talked up our podcast so much to like get us some sponsors. That motherfucker got us Manscaped.
Yes.
If you go to manscaped.com and you use promo code NFHC, you get 20% off of anything.
Yeah.
And we get paid. So, fucking win-win. Yeah. So, do that shit. All of you, everyone. Just, like, they won't nick your balls. And ours will be here tomorrow.
And then we have to...
Today.
The thing, we have to use it, and then kind of review it, and then say our honest opinion about it during an ad read that is coming very soon. We just can't do it yet, because...
It's like that whole thing you heard when you were younger. If you don't use it, you'll lose it. You know?
Yes, so, exactly.
All I'm saying is I've been saying that big things are coming, and you motherfuckers act like you... All you people out there just act like nothing was actually happening. But big things
are
fucking happening. Go ahead.
To piggyback on that... Well, this is part of the bigger things I have in the pipeline. If it works out and it is beneficial to both parties, I have a dispensary lined up for us.
Yeah.
We're fucking doing it, guys.
Yeah.
So,
with the help of everybody that listens and participates and promotes, it's awesome. It's a good feel. It was a good feel week amongst a week of bullshit. Of other areas, but anyway, it's a good time, and the community's dicks are gonna look good by Christmas.
We've been talking about it all week long and having conversations, and like one of the thoughts on my mind is like thinking and hoping that like Alan would be proud of where this has gone.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Especially with this step now, like I think about it and I'm like. Like, I think I hear Alan's voice on how stoked he would be, like, to get this and just be like, fuck yeah, dude! You know, like, I hope in my heart of hearts that he would, you know, he'd be fucking proud of,
he absolutely was. The
steps we've taken, you know, because, you know, we had the conversation, like, if we didn't carry on, fucking we'd be haunted by Alan's ghost for the rest of our lives.
Yeah. Well, all I know is we can have toned balls for Porklift now, and that's fucking all that matters.
Toned balls.
I can't wait for my scrotox.
If Dylan would have got fucking home on time to grab the goddamn care package we were sent, we could have reviewed it right now, but we can't say.
I would have put my balls on camera.
Yeah.
You know, sorry, I fucking wasn't home
when the
thing got...
Look at it! Just wobbling your fucking... Your crumpled hot air balloon in your bag up top.
Nah, dude. Like, look at all this bubble gum I found!
Get in there, Dylan.
But yeah, so definitely if you're thinking about shaving your hair down there, you should get a Manscaped and then use our code NFHC at the website.
Yes.
Because that's like a new, like, maybe you don't want to fucking sign up on Patreon, but you're like, man, I really wish I could like help out.
I wish my dick looked good by Christmas, you know?
We'll be in code NFHC. We'll be in full, like, promoting mode next week and to get all set up. We've got details, all that good stuff. Dude. We'll get going. And so after this episode comes out and we do the next one on the 11th, we're really gonna
it's the real campaign yeah. starts, but yeah
the real campaign is going to hit,
but it's fun, so, and
it's great.
We should have a private fucking Patreon tier in the Discord of where we actually try out the thing with cameras on. We're like,
yeah. I mean, I pretty much stopped shaving because I cut my balls so much.
Yeah, dude. This one doesn't cut your balls apparently. Yeah. Unless you're like trying to cut your balls. I guess you don't cut your balls. I don't know. We're gonna fucking find out.
Multiple.
We're gonna fuck around and then find out.
Yeah,
I'm excited.
I'll save those stories for later.
No, I'm gonna shave my whole body with it
on air.
Yeah, my fucking head and my face. I'm gonna start with my balls.
We don't have enough time for me to shave on air.
I'm gonna start with the balls and move to the mustache.
Just this section alone is gonna put that thing through the fucking ringer.
Like, it's time for a charge.
Yeah,
I don't know, bro.
There's more, but it's gray too, so you can't really tell. But I mean, look at that tuft.
Yeah,
it's called the lawnmower 4.0. I'm pretty sure they can handle it.
Yeah, but it's not called the fucking chainsaw fucking 4.0.
We haven't tried it yet. We have to make sure we say.
Yeah. So anyway, no, it'll work. I know it will. I'm just talking shit about my own chest hair and how gross
it is. I do want you on this episode right now, Jay, though. Like, during when we went and had a nice little chicken wing meetup last night
at Chicken Wing
Cap Sports Bar and Grill.
That place was, let's get them to fucking sponsor.
Winner of chicken wing sauces, man. Like, they had so many, they had 30 options of their sauce combinations that they thought of. And then it's like at the bottom, it's like, you can mix this however you want.
Yep. I found one, and that's all I fucking need. It was so damn good.
But anyway, onion rings,
those onion rings, Matt.
Oh yeah. That's so. I learned last night that Jay will actually test out a bar's food. It's only a bar that has food, but he tests it out. If the onion rings dipped into their barbecue sauce that they chose all together is good, the rest of the food is safe for human consumption.
Yeah, that's I judge a place's like I judge how well they do anything at the bar by their onion ring.
Yeah, and last night, so I'm an old man. I've never dipped an onion ring into barbecue sauce, and it changed my whole perspective, dude.
Never had a fucking Western bacon cheeseburger?
I have, but there's so much stuff in them.
That's different. The Carl's Jr. barbecue sauce isn't like regular. Like, it's a super tangy. Like, but good smoky, like what we had last night, good smoky barbecue sauce.
Yeah.
And those onion rings were perfect. It has to be a good, has to be a solid batter that doesn't crumble, but has to be not like doughy in the middle. And the onion
doughy in the middle, but it's got much back.
Yeah, it has to be biteable. Like, you can't bite it and then it's all, because it's not, it's got to be a fucking way.
So,
there is only one way.
I'm calling it now, dude. Caps is the new NFHC fucking hangout for food bar stuff, dude. Like, it's a good,
I think so, man.
It's a good open format to just go, like, because, I don't know. I like going to shitty dive bars.
Is that personally. Our fucking? Is that where we're gonna write off our business?
That's our
new office. Business meeting.
That's our new. It's our new.
It's our HQ.
Yeah.
Well, the podcast was spawned out of the fucking patio of Gallagher's and practice studios. This will be our new bar, restaurant, bullshit place that we can go and get cheap beers and rad things.
I want to try that little tap house too. That's right down there in Deer Valley.
The Tav.
No, not the Tav. I've been there. There's a tap house.
We can stay away from the Tav.
Yeah. You'll get COVID from sitting on the fucking chairs like Dylan did.
I did get COVID from the
Tav. That's where you got the coof, bud.
Go back a few episodes.
Well, I went somewhere else too, but
remember when Dylan had COVID and he almost passed out getting the mail?
Yeah.
Those good times.
Just east of it's right there, I think, on 7th in Deer Valley. It's a tap. There's a tap house right there. Used to be that breakfast joint next to Habanero Fresh.
Yes, I know what you're talking about.
I'd like to check that out. But yeah, we have options.
They brew their own beer there, dude. And you're gonna live closer. It's all coming together finally.
I mean, if we want to take it way back to the old school, there's a fucking Awful House.
Yes, it's true. They don't have beer there or chicken wings, so fuck that.
But they have onions and mayonnaise.
Yeah, and waitresses that are 90 years old that want to buy fucking weed off me.
I don't want onions or mayonnaise, but I will take chicken wings.
Excuse me, waitress. This onion, this chunk of this onion is really tough. Oh, it's my tooth.
Oh, God, dude. Speaking of...
that's a possibility.
Speaking of last episode, I brought up Circle K teat when I was in the Jack in the Box drive-thru and that fucking... That chick that looked like Kid Rock's been homeless for 40 years with her tits out.
So Kid Rock.
I ran into her again. She was just crossing this. I was at a stoplight and she just walked in front of me. Tit still kind of fucking out. It was the same shirt. I kind of felt bad, but whatever.
Just go buy her a new shirt.
Just go.
Here. Put them flapjacks
give
away.
Give her that one. Give her the one you're wearing.
I'm not giving
here,
her
lady.
My...
You look like soggy baguettes with the burnt ends.
I'm not giving her my fucking Oregon Trail shirt that says you have died of dysentery.
What if? hold on, let me think about how much I want to say
no,
this.
No, she can't be a guest, Dylan.
What if we get a stack of shirts and we all have them in our cars and we just hand them out to homeless people?
Okay.
That's a fucking great idea.
It just says, what the fuck's a podcast or money?
It just says patreon.com/NFHC podcast. And it's rude.
Give them a shirt and 10 bucks. Be like, here's 10 bucks. Wear this shirt.
Barf broad shirts.
Yeah.
Yeah. You look like you've been barfing out.
We can't make that many.
Fuck, man. We just give out. Remember that shitty-ass band that got real popular, though, here in all Digital Summer? They just put their stickers all over everything.
Everywhere.
So
that's good marketing, but...
I wouldn't be surprised if, like, they slapped one on a homeless man's face when they were driving by.
So, when I was in this band, Kawama...
Yeah.
It was pronounced Coma, but it was spelled Kawama.
Yeah. Like, with that dirtbag song thief.
Because it stood for the Korean American Metal Assault, because
he was Korean and you were American and you assaulted people with metal.
I guess. Oof, whatever. So anyway, we had a bunch of Coma stickers, and we decided to everywhere we saw a Digital Summer sticker, we put the Coma sticker over it, like but where you could still read theirs. Yeah, that was pretty fun. We had like hundreds and hundreds of Coma stickers covering Digital Summer stickers.
Damn
everywhere.
It, it's pretty good.
It's just trying to capitalize on there. It's like when you're like this podcast and then like the Rich Dickman show wants to like capitalize on us and then he slaps his sticker on our show all the time. It's the same thing.
We stickered the earth back in the brick days. For one, we had these first ones, we had these really shitty paper ones that you didn't even know it said brick.
A rainstorm would wipe it out.
yeah. And then we finally got like the vinyl ones and the other ones everywhere we went. Parking signs, like handicap signs, tables. We'd get up and leave from somewhere and slap one on the table. Just anywhere we went. Like, oh, you have a sticker on you? Yeah, cool. Peel, slap. Anywhere we could possibly stick one. If we had them on us, I mean, we would... We'd be at Metro Center, fucking everything. We'd walk by inside, pop on the windows, fucking everywhere we could, on a chair, park bench, fucking everywhere.
Dude, the shitty ass Hard Rock Cafe downtown Phoenix, one of my earlier bands, is it Blue Collar Murder or whatever?
Yeah.
I always hated that fucking name, but anyway, somebody stuck one of our stickers on their inside of their shitter stall and they fucking emailed me 6 months after the show trying to charge me $500 for repainting the bathroom because of one sticker. And I told him to go fuck himself. And he was like, what the fuck? No, this is your sticker. I was like, I can't control what people do with our fucking merch. And I was like, but then I was like, oh man, coincidentally, somebody put a fucking Hard Rock sticker on my amp and the tubes fucking melted it to the thing. And it cost $600. Do you want to give me a check? Yeah. Fuck, I was like, split the difference. Give me $100.
That was Ghost Life's first show.
It was. I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you guys went on after us, but we were throwing fucking 808s.
It was our it was our show. Like,
yeah.
That was like Manny sometimes did like good things. Like, yeah. For that being our first show, we're like, the fucking Hard Rock? Because it was you guys, us, and Real.
Yeah, but people were eating fucking spaghetti and meatballs to our breakdowns.
Yeah, it's like we went on, we're not really heavy, and then fucking Brett's just all fucking right in people's faces. They're like, ah, I'm just trying to fucking have my fucking fettuccine.
Dude, that band was fucked up because every time I turn around after sound check, Brett's like, your medicine's up on your amp. And I was like, what? And I turn around and there's just five shots of fucking tequila or whatever he decided to buy everybody.
And Brady's off in the corner hanging himself with his guitar strap.
Looking like fucking Peter Weller.
Yeah, dude. Fucking Robro Cop.
Robro Cop?
Dude, I'm sure I've told it on here before, but that fucking, that show, I think it was at the Cajun house where fucking he went to see the fucking...
Oh, yeah, choked himself. He said the guitar spin was a fucking big move in the early 2000s.
Yeah, he went to do the spin and it just all went wrong. He ended up like this. Forever trying to get his bass off him, and he's being choked too, like he's basically fucking arm triangling himself. And he's like panicking on the stage, and Chase is just staring at him. He's all fucking stupid Chase fucking just staring at him, and like I'm like, Brady's about to die on stage. I'm like, this is gonna be their greatest show ever.
We would have made it after that, dude.
Yeah, God, it was so fucking funny. There's the other one too where he put it through the ceiling. You remember that? I'm sure you remember that one.
Oh yeah, because that was
fucking went to do it. It's all bink.
Because that was a dirty, like hardcore grindy band. So we played all the worst places, but it was rad because it was just packed with dirty, smelly people.
Yeah,
that would beat the fuck out of each other and throw people through fucking gear.
Yeah, and Brady had to do things like that because his stage performance was like he just got braces put on his legs.
Like when Forrest Gump starts running?
He was like, he was like Frankenstein. Like he was just, his knees didn't bend. Like he was just, I was like, he's going to pass out. You know, like when people stand in line with their like legs locked for too long.
Yeah.
And they pass out. I'm like, he's going to pass out. He was just like. It was so bad.
That motherfucker. He was cool to me, then he was a dick to me, then he was a dick to me, then cool to me. He was weird. But anyway.
He never finished paying me for that fucking Viper.
Damn it. And also, like, his input for writing songs would be he'd stop the whole writing process in the studio and he'd be like, hey, bro, whatever comes next right here needs to be fucking good. And he'd back up all slow, like we're supposed to be like, yeah, it is going to be good, right? Like, we should write good stuff at the next part. I think that's some valid input, bud.
I remember when we were sharing the basement. When we were sharing the basement, and I was writing that song with you guys.
Mm-hmm.
The whatever, like, I was just, for some reason, I'm all, dude, I got an idea. And like, it was a really cool song, and I had an idea for the bass, and Brady was just like, it just wasn't there. And I'm like, let me play it real quick. And I fucking, you know, pretty much wrote the whole song while Brady watched.
And then, oh no,
when it came time for him to actually have to play it, it took a long time. Long time.
He's sitting there looking at you playing his bass.
And we were like, we were getting down too. Like, I remember we're just all, we're like, fuck yeah, and we're just fucking jamming. And I'm like, okay, here, dude.
Oh, he's like that fucking drawing of Mario banging Princess Peach, but Luigi's in the background all in the shadow smoking a cigar. Oh,
that's so funny. God damn it.
Oh, fuck.
The good old days.
The good old times.
Yeah, I think the basement was probably some of my favorite times of music.
Yeah, that's when I learned that you like to, you noticed the attractiveness of homeless chicks. Back on fucking Circle K, I don't think this would be up your alley.
She was hot, dude.
Not Circle K teeth, the chick when we were building out the other studio.
Yeah, that chick was fucking hot.
I never saw her.
She, like, it took me a minute to realize she was homeless, because eventually I smelled the onion, you know, like the armpit. But I'm like, maybe she's just walking back to her apartment from the gas station right here, grabbing a fucking Mars bar or some shit, you know? And then I was like, oh, fuck. This broad's hot. Like, she has an odor to her. So, but she was, it was, maybe it could have, she could have been newly homeless. Who knows?
I just went to
before the streets got to her.
I just went to get us thirst busters, dude, where you're hanging drywall in the fucking basement.
I was trying to bust that thirst.
Dude, so if I was homeless,
you'd be a hot homeless person.
Well, if I was homeless and then for like a while, and then I was finally not homeless and I was doing okay, you know, the first thing I would do would be,
what's that?
Manscaped.com. Get a lawnmower 4.0 with promo code NFHC.
Oh yeah,
there you go. 20% off, free shipping.
That's what I would do.
That is a super rad opportunity that we were fucking able to get, I guess. You know, I don't know what I'll say.
It's kind of a funny sponsorship
because we talk about dicks and balls.
I mean, it fits well with our theme, but the fact that we are this, like, I mean, I don't trim shit, but
yeah, the carpet's not going to match the drapes.
If you looked at us, you'd be like, why do they need to trim? Because they don't.
But no, man.
Like the other products they have, I am honestly, I can't wait to try the ball toner. Like,
I thought you guys were joking. There's a ball toner.
It's in our package, dude.
Well, Dylan wasn't at home to get it. It said not like, safe location I, to place it.
I think about in the old Bugs Bunny cartoon when he'd throw the toner on his face and his face would shrink. Like, I want that to happen to my testicles.
Your fucking balls are going to look like that guy's face from Beetlejuice when he's sitting there next to him in the waiting room.
Yeah, but smooth. I want my balls.
It's going to cinch up your sack.
I want my 12-year-old balls back.
Here, let me,
wait, it's going to fucking smooth out the rinks, dude?
Yeah, dude. It's going to be, that's why I call it fucking Scrotox, dude. Not a fucking rink, and dude, it'll probably get rid of the seam too.
A seamless bag probably looks weird as shit, dude. Just like a smooth orb.
This looks like an elbow.
Your ball bag looks like an elbow. Yeah. Like, balls aren't rad looking anyway, but if they were smoother, it seems weirder to me, right?
The enemy I know
is different than the enemy that I'm imagining.
I have a description, but I'm not gonna say it because we'll lose it.
Yeah, just keep it to yourself.
So, yeah.
Anyway, when the fucking ad reads start, just don't clown on us for shilling, because we have to do it. We have to do live reads about it, but whatever.
Dude, I'm gonna crush it.
This is like the thing that we're trying to do. If you fucking don't like it, go fuck yourself. I don't know. Don't buy it. Like, come on now. Like, we're trying to grow here. This is how you do it. We gotta read some ads sometimes.
Yeah,
to do that.
But then you fucking buzz down everything that grows.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of funny.
What's that?
We went from like first off, you know, thanks to Crazy Cactus for all of the the first sponsor of the show.
Yes.
No longer a sponsor of the show, but you know, shit happens. Walter, of course, is Walter, and he's.
He has a wall of woe, I hear.
He has a wall of woe, and his sponsor is great. But this is like the podcast sponsor.
Yeah, next we're going to be selling stamps.com and mattresses.
Yeah.
They're on the list, bro. They're on the list. Like, if we can, if really we can be like, hey, we're sponsored by Manscaped. You know, like, we already have, now that we have this sponsor, we can throw that in the, like, email of trying to get other sponsors, and they'll be like, oh, they're sponsored by Manscaped. Manscaped's fucking, that's a legit company.
Yeah.
My balls are fucking toned. If Manscaped believes in them, we believe in them. Here we go. Then we're fucking off to the, you know, whatever.
That's our new tagline, NFHC podcast. We're legitimized.
It's like when I asked a local band if they wanted to have their song at the end of the fucking episode, and they're like, we need this, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, nah, man, never mind. It's cool. Like, we've had Failure and Amir and shit on. Like, we're good.
Yeah.
Like, get fucked.
Yeah. I'm trying to find their ball toner. Give me a second.
I'm curious. But anyway, Jay had a... Jay said some other trimmer back in the day fucking nicked a wrinkle.
Remember? Yeah, I was going to save that one.
Oh, come on.
All right. So,
drink, because this is the fucking.
You're pulling my bag.
Because we went to a bar last night and this almost came out, and I was like, no, just tell me now.
Yeah. Okay. I'll tell you now. It was going to, I mean, I have many stories. This is probably the best one, though. So, back in the day when I was back in my youth, I was shorn like a swimmer. Like, not a fucking a follicle. Yeah, not a follicle on me, yeah. Right? Yeah. So, I had a trimmer, like one of the bigger, like, wall trimmers, because I always cut my own hair. I'd always, like, shaved you, like, undercut, whatever.
A bowl cut, bro?
Yeah, whatever. So, I also used that to shave everything else, right?
Yeah.
But on the side, it had a little gauge, like, or little lever that you could raise the guard on it.
Oh yeah, so I remember those ones, the WAHL ones. Yeah.
Ball. Yeah. So what I would do is I'd keep my thumb on that to keep it long, so I didn't fucking so basically it didn't do to my balls what that machine did to my hand. And just pull it in and chew it up, right? Because, you know, when you just nick down there, it's just like, here's all of the blood in your body.
Yeah.
You know, you just bleed. Like, it's just, I don't know, it sucks. Oh, yeah, and then you're stuck with, like, it doesn't scab.
It's called a root. You know? It's called a root for a reason, dude. Like, there's a lot of fuck. There's a lot of shit going on.
You gotta lay there with, like, your legs up to a fan to, like, dry off the blood. Like, I got places to be, blood. Stop it. So anyways... I was down in the gooch region, and I'm getting in there, and it's like, I'm not flexible. I can't, like, use the mirror behind me, like, look at, because I shave my asshole and everything. So
do you run quicker with your
asshole? I was in the sphincter region, and as I'm going in, I was like, I couldn't keep all my hand down there. I needed to, like, slide down to the end of the clippers to, like, get in there.
Yeah.
And, like, I had to make sure that guard was at the high level, not the, like, the flush level. Well, as I'm pushing back there, it closes that.
Ooh.
And so as I'm going in, it fucking nicks the wrinkles in my asshole. And it's, I'm like, hey! You know, like fucking, like I just been sodomized in jail. And so I'm like, and by this time, when I have my leg up on the sink, like, I'm like this.
Ooh.
I'm like this in the bathroom. I'm like, this is the mirror. And I'm like, that's not good at all. And it's just all this blood in my asshole. And I'm like, oh God, that is not good. So now I'm like this. So then I have my other hand and I've got a wad of toilet paper. And I'm just like, I'm like looking at the damage and I'm patting my asshole to, like, you know, to dry the blood up. And I'm like, dude, it won't fucking stop. So then, for the remainder of the day, you have a gummy asshole, because it can't scab. You know what I mean? So, like, all day long, you're like, it's like, fuck.
Everybody, you know, it's drink. Like,
it's like a bad wipe. You know, like, you're like, I don't think I wiped good enough. But in this case, it was just coagulated blood in my asshole.
It was a massacre on your asshole.
Yeah, dude. Good thing I wore. Yeah, an assacre. good thing I wore underwear back then. I'm winded from that story, man.
So Matt, I put a link in the chat. You can read what the ball toner does if you click that link.
Good segue.
It's the crop reviver.
Oh no, fucking
yeah, the crop, the yeah, that's what it's called.
So you you just nicked.
Oh, dude, it's like right now, that's all you have to do. Like it was, it was like you know, you hear it like.
Like when a dentist drill bottoms out for a second.
Yeah. No, it was fast. It was like them. You know what I mean? Like it was quick because I knew like you feel the vibration. You're like
feel the vibration. Oh
no! Oh man, this ain't gonna be good. I hope no young lady wants to toss my salad later.
What, you just got some dressing?
It's gonna be like she's tossing a bag of coins.
licking nickels, dude.
Oh. Yeah, dude. Fucking. I think you sat on a buffalo nickel.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, how so? It's tastes like
it
coins.
It tastes like fountain water with all the coins.
She's down there. She's all change. I'm like, all right, I'll start in on you. She's like, no, it tastes like change.
Oh, God.
Yeah. It happens, you know.
That's a fucking, yeah, because, you know, I guess your intestine, the end of it's your asshole, and that's where all your blood and your fucking digestion goes. Oh, man.
Yeah, well, I mean, think about, like, a hemorrhoid. It's so easy for a hemorrhoid to pop.
I've never had one!
We've seen them, though.
I've seen them.
Directly pointed at you.
I woke up to my father looking into our friend's asshole on a Saturday when I didn't even know you guys were over. Bro, is this a hemorrhoid? And I walk out, I'm like, what the fuck? Ah. My dad's looking at my friend's asshole.
I just hear, come in here, Matt. It looks like a purple Skittle.
It's no good. It's not a good time.
Come on, man. What was going on in your house?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
You grew up in a wrong time, Dylan.
Yeah.
What, shortly after you?
The height of our youth.
The height of our youth is waking up on a Saturday and turning left. All hungover when I still lived with my parents to peer down a stairwell to my father looking into my drummer's asshole to confirm whether it's an STD or a hemorrhoid. Anyway.
Well, you know what?
What?
Would have been good if, while looking at his asshole, his balls had used the crop reviver.
The ball spray toner that is just what the doctor ordered for your buds below. It uses witch hazel extracts to keep your high friction areas cool, calm, and protected after a good shave.
That sounds like some
aloe vera and witch hazel. That sounds like some shit you need to put on your balls. Powerful odor defense. That's good for Arizona in the summer.
I don't stink.
You don't stink?
Guys, I don't wear underwear anymore. There's no I get perfect airflow, dude. No, I get airflow. They're not all tightened up like they smell fucking.
Listen,
beautiful.
It's cruelty-free, dye-free, paraben-free, and it's vegan, so you can still get some fucking yum-yum on the fucking hum-hum without worrying about
the only meat going in that broad's mouth is yours.
That's Manscaped's new tagline. Get some yum-yum on that hum-hum.
This shit's only $8.99.
But less than that with 20% off.
God damn it. It's all infomercial now. Fucking.
You know what? While we're talking about things that are happening, I threw this idea out.
I heard they're big things.
And no one ever really said yes or no, so I'm going to say it anyway. I don't give a shit. Fuck it. It's my show right now.
What are you doing?
I'm throwing the whole podcast into fucking open beta. We're open beta testing. I'm gonna fuck, like, if you join our Discord between now and the 4-year episode, you can just fucking listen to the Friday Night Live show for now.
Whoa, everybody's a Dilly's kid.
Everybody's a Dilly's kid right now because I'm restructuring everything and things are gonna change and, like, Patreon people, like,
they're getting a Founders Pack surprise.
well, there's going to be a founders pack for people that were here before season four. You know, there's going to be lots of things, and like prices might, some tiers might switch around. I don't know. We don't know exactly know what's going to happen yet.
It's a lot of work.
Big things are coming.
Dylan has to do
more. Big things are coming.
Management's going to need you to. Management's going to need you to put that in writing so it can be addressed on the socials.
But yeah.
But really, yeah, if you join, I'll, you know, the Discord, whatever the fucking link for the Discord is. If we have 12 more people boost our Discord server, we can make our custom NFHC link. But yeah. That's like, you know, that's like a
12 people.
Homeslice says, manscaped.com.
Homeslice says, Dilly's kids, Nizbitches, and Jaybies.
Fuck, dude.
Fucking Jaybies. But never forget.
I'm just saying.
It's the spooky fucking month now, dude.
Things are happening, and we're trying. Like, this is. My it's whole everything is about growth. My life, personally, is about
and
growth.
And it's serious. Regardless of how we all act, like fucking children, it's. I do. I know I give you shit, Dylan. I support you. You know I do. We've discussed it. But there's this. I can't help but do what I do. But just know I'm sorry. I support you. And
contrarian me?
That word's not allowed to be said anymore on this show.
Yeah.
Ever again.
You JB me?
Yeah, I JB you. But you know I support you. People can't know how we talk outside the podcast. That ruins the vibe.
No, you That's actually, it's the same. Except for last night when Jay was just like a businessman.
But yeah. Then I went right back to documents in front of us.
I had it face down, too. I'm all.
He's like, yeah.
After we read over like fucking legal stuff, it just turned into a podcast episode at a bar.
And then I was just talking about all the things that we can do.
That's how I learned about a fucking nicked butthole story. Then I was like, just tell me that later, bro.
And right after we finished eating, I told
him. Well, Dylan wasn't done eating because he took 9 years to finish them last two.
He wasn't done, though, because he kept eating after that.
That guy refused to give Dylan a to-go box.
Yeah, so he just ate. So when we get there, so this is funny. So I get there first, I go inside, I get a table.
Yes!
Football's on, and the sound don't bother me because I like football. So I sit directly under this TV, not realizing that is the sound for the whole area we're sitting in.
In Dylan's
I'm just
ear.
Oblivious. It's in yeah, Dylan's. I'm oblivious. It's been a long day. I'm just like, I'm sitting. And as I'm sitting there, I'm like, I'm going to sit in the middle because Matt and I aren't going to fit on the same side, for one. Dylan comes in. He sits down, and for some reason, the bench that he was on was much lower. I'm not even exaggerating. The table was up to here on him. He was trying to drink my drink, and it was like. He sat down, and I was waiting. I was like, I bet the waiter thinks that this is my kid, and how cool it is that my kid has a beard like me. And then so he sits down, and I'm saying something, and he's. Dylan's like this, hands in his lap, and he's all, I'm all, you're fucking high, aren't you? He's all, I'm real fucking high.
Oh,
it's been a long day, and instantly goes from chill to, like, slightly angry.
Why are you questioning my highness, bro? Just let me be me, okay?
I know this isn't a
business meeting, but, you know, I'm still going to come to it fucking high.
It's different. I see you high on here, but I don't see you that much in person anymore. So when I saw you in person, you can
you feel the highness.
Right when you sat down, it kicked in. Is what it seemed like. Like you're just like.
So now imagine this. Like, allegedly, you're my boss, okay? And like, you see me like that every single day, but you only ever see me like that. So you just assume that that's just how I look.
You're just like, you know that Dylan guy that works for us? He's just always got this like lazy face.
Dude, I hit my pen
hard.
Okay, so one time, so like 17 years ago, I was working at this job and I hit my pen. in my car, and I fucking held it in real hard, and then I was like, all right, good for the rest of the day. And then I walked over back to go inside as my boss's truck rolls in. I'm like, ah, shit, that's going to be a fucking... this is going to be hitting real hard right about then. It was a good time. I just cracked jokes on him, like, about dumb shit.
Yeah.
And he just kind of plays along, and I'm like, man, I'm so fucking high right now. But that was, like, 17 years ago, not today.
I didn't even... Oh, go ahead.
I have a similar situation. The first time I did acid, I was at my friend Chris's house, and I was with my buddy Chris and Keith. And it's the first time I did and McClay. And it's the first time I did acid. And the three of us did it. Chris didn't. So it was me, Keith, and McClay all on acid. And we're at Chris's house, and his dad Tracy. And a lot of my friends know Matt. You know, he just recently passed away.
Yeah,
but. I'm like, I need to go smoke a cigarette. And Chris comes out and he's fucking with me. He's smoking a joint. And Chris is always fucks with people. So he's kind of fucking with me. I'm like, why do you tell everybody you don't smoke weed? You're smoking a joint right now. He's all, it's a cigarette. I'm like, I'm not an idiot. He's always a
dick about it.
I'm on acid, but I'm not an idiot. And he's like, ah.
He's always a dick.
So we go inside. I come back out for a smoke again later on. And I'm out there by myself. And his dad comes out, Tracy. And I'm sitting there, I'm just smoking a cig, and it's nighttime. And he just starts telling jokes, and he had the best fucking jokes. Like, it was great. So he's just laying it thick on me because I'm high as fuck on acid, and I'm laughing my ass off. And he has no clue that I'm on acid, but I'm just enjoying it because the jokes, and I'm high, and I'm laughing my ass off. So then McClay comes running outside, and he's like, hey, Tracy. He's like, bro, are you... You okay? I'm up, dude. Fucking Tracy's telling jokes. I'm fucking great. Yeah, just gotta hide the high sometimes.
Yeah, and I didn't even mean to pull my trademark move of showing up 20 minutes late, but it still happened.
Dude, so I thought I was gonna be late because I was working on a project, which in the beta test of the podcast currently, we're gonna beta test some new bits. So I was working on it. And I'm like, all right, I can work on this for like 15 minutes and then I get the fuck out of here. Well, I got stoned and then I was like really like, I was in like a flow. I'm like, oh shit, this is working. And then you said, fuck! I saw a text that said you were closing up shop and you're like way closer to the place than me. I'm like, oh fuck. And I didn't have my shoes on or anything.
Oh yeah, bud.
So I was like, got all my shit together and like ran out of the house and I get there and then you show up like 30 minutes later. I'm like, God damn it.
I didn't mean it.
And I got there exactly when I said I would be there. 5 o'clock. Said I'll be there by 5. I got there at 5 o'clock.
I was at there like 5:40. I'm sorry.
There was
We already knew. You already said that you were going to be closing up.
That's true.
5:30-ish.
Yeah.
But... I was honestly expecting Dylan, like, I would have got there and Dylan would have already been there.
And this...
I had to get this thing done.
I missed a turn because this fucking cunt wouldn't let me over. I'm like, God damn it. And I was so tired
and, like, I honestly didn't want to meet up at all, but I knew we had to. Like, I was just exhausted and I felt like shit. That storm was coming in and my fucking allergies were all nasty.
All day with a headache from that fucking storm.
Anyway. Yeah, I'm still, you can see to my eyes, these fucking allergies are killing me. Maybe because I don't have my glasses on either.
I'll heal you, girl.
So I got there and I'm like, I'm gonna smoke a cig and I'm sitting there. I'm like, I'm not even joining. I'm like, these motherfuckers are gonna be late. I started getting like pissy on the inside. I was like,
Jay pissy at the start of an event?
Weird. Yeah, I go in and I sit down and I'm like, I'm hot, like I'm sweaty, it was nasty in there, and I'm like sitting trying to cool off, and I'm like, I didn't want to be there, and I'm like thinking about my drive home, and I'm like, we're gonna be fucking late, and every person that walked in, I'm like, got angrier when that person wasn't one of you guys, and I'm like, and I got my pitcher of water, and I just started kind of drinking it, and I was like, and I started watching football, and I chilled out, and Dylan's super high face made me feel
it. There ain't nothing about watching tight ends and wide receivers, you know? Fucking
see, if I come in just super lit, it's real hard to be like upset because you know that I'm just like, shit, sorry.
It's like yelling at a kid with special needs. Like,
yelling at a kid with special needs.
Because I'm just going to be like, yeah, man. There's like seven lights between like, my house and that place.
Oh.
And every single one of them was red as I got to it. Like, come the fuck on, man. I'm trying to get somewhere.
It's like special needs kid, like, what the fuck? And they're still, huh? Like, oh, I can't be mad at that.
Oh, man, look at the size of his forehead.
Yeah. Look at the size of his lips and his ass. He's special.
Fuck.
They got dumps like a truck. What?
Oh, what? No. Well, anyway, it was fun last night actually being in the real, and we're going to do that more.
I don't know. I almost forget, like...
That's our home base now. Caps is
home base.
I
forget the shape of you guys. I miss your shape.
The shape of you.
Oh. Yeah. The shape of dudes to come.
Get lost in the shape of me to come. Oh. It's the weirdest.
Get lost in the shape of me and come.
Oh, shit. Anyway, do you get anything else, Dylan?
I finished watching that fucking Inspiration 4 docuseries on Netflix about the civilian
space flight boys
around the Earth, where they orbited the Earth for 3 days, like farther than the space station.
Oh,
that shit made me cry like 18 separate times.
Grow up, Dylan.
Dude, I don't know what the fuck it is about drugs.
Yeah.
But God, I'm sensitive to like things. I don't know, and it was designed to be like wholesome, nonstop, just moments. Like it was definitely built around because there's four people. One's a billionaire. Nobody gives a shit about him.
Oh.
One is.
But
some,
he obviously
like,
works harder than everybody.
Yeah. Fucking hard work and piece of shit.
Yeah, what a fucking. He works way more hours than me, so he makes a.
The billionaire is Elaz's fucking twin brother. Like, he reminds me of Elaz a little bit. It's weird.
Is it a space Pollock?
Yeah.
Is that an offensive episode? Yeah, I can't do that.
So, anyway, the doc. So
well, Elaz is our tech Pollock.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, Jay.
He was telling
that wasn't
me.
For you.
He was
that
telling
was for...
me. He was telling me, Dylan. Go ahead.
I know you know. You know I'm never talking to you when you're telling stories, but I'm talking
over
you.
I know you're
just
always talking to me.
It's always to somebody else. I'll never
address
you.
I thought that if I waited till like the end, you'd be worn out from all the talking you already did, where I shut up for like 5 straight minutes and just let you go.
All right, go ahead, Dylan. Jay!
You know?
I was active.
Let's slide him in the back seat. Dylan in the front seat. Let's go.
If you don't know about the fucking flight that happened in space, Jay.
I did not know, and you're...
Okay, that's not necessary. I moved my mic.
No, I honestly didn't know about it till you mentioned it. I was like, wait, what? Explain it to me again now?
So this is what it was. I'll break it down. Like,
okay.
Essentially, this billionaire named Jared fucking something. I can't remember his
Fogel?
Last name. No.
Oh.
Not him.
Subways in space.
I don't remember. He started some company, whatever. Grew, made a bunch of money. He like flies jets and whatever. All this stuff. He wanted to go to space. How the fuck do I go to space? I got a bunch of fucking money. Let's talk to Elon Musk.
Oh.
And they set it up so basically, so he was the main guy. It's a civilian, no real astronauts in the whole thing. It's all they wanted to raise $200,000 for St. Jude's Children's Hospital. So that guy threw up like the first like $50 million or whatever.
Yeah.
For the thing or what? He threw in a bunch of money. They ended up raising way over the amount. So the whole thing was like they designed it around the Children's Hospital to make it seem less like some billionaire trying to go to space.
Oh, okay.
Which was cool. So like the first chick they picked was kind of who the whole doc was based around because she had like cancer in her leg when she was a child and survived and has like a prosthetic like inside of her leg and shit. So she's like the first cancer survivor with a prosthetic to fucking
in
go to
space.
Space.
That's a lot on your resume, dude.
And she's like a nurse that works at like the children's hospital or whatever. So like,
calm down, lady. Okay, you just made everybody feel like shit.
Yeah, so like the whole thing is like
fucking
really
bronze,
like
dude,
heavy.
This can't just have one item.
Calm down, Little Miss Inspiration.
It's like super, super heavy on like her life because she was one that they just picked her. They're like, hey, do you want to go to space because of like your story? And she's like, the fucking, yeah.
The fucking what?
Which is kind of funny. So in the doc, I thought it was funny. She's like, my brother has just like, all he's ever thought about his whole life is going to space, but I get to do it because somebody randomly just asked me. And I'm like, I bet you that dude's so fucking mad. He's like, this bitch gets cancer
one.
Yeah, like, fuck. Oh, I couldn't get cancer to go to space and she gets to go. So anyway, it's pretty heavy around her. The one middle-aged guy who's just like a dude with a wife, they barely ever show that motherfucker.
Terrible backstory.
Like, no, dude, like, they give you almost no backstory on this guy because, like, he's so uninteresting or something. I don't know. Like, it's so focused around the one girl. Anyway.
There's another broad, too, right? Like,
she's like a doctor. Yeah, she's in her. She has, like, she did a video contest to. So the dude donated money to the children's hospital and got randomly picked to be one of the people. Like, this is literally how they pick the people. Like, one dude is a random fucking drawing. Hey, bro, you want to go to space, man? Wait, what? I guess? Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure, man.
Philip, you're funny. Nice prank call, bud.
Exactly. Yeah, hangs up on. Go fuck yourself.
So they had the billionaire, they had the cancer chick, and then they had the dude that guy. Won. And then like the other chick.
It's like the new Gilligan's Island.
Yeah, exactly. The doctor chick, she did a video. They had like a contest for like everyone, why do you want to go to space or whatever? And they picked her.
And some she was, guy.
She's like a doctor and I don't know, whatever. But they like taught him how to fly jets and like they went through the whole fucking Christ. Like full on astronaut training. It was pretty intense. They hiked some crazy fucking mountain in a blizzard.
I wouldn't have passed.
Dude, no, like I was watching, I'm like, I can't go
to space. They're not going to a planet. Why do they have to hike a mountain in a blizzard?
They were really just testing their like ability to handle high stress situations.
Yeah. Oh, so like it's different from when you had COVID and got winded getting the mail.
Yeah, exactly.
What are your qualifications? Really I almost checked the mail once.
Yeah. So,
the whole thing is, you know, it's 5 episodes, I believe. It's drawn out.
What service is it on?
Netflix.
Oh, okay.
It's a Netflix. It's called Inspiration 4. I can't remember the whole thing.
It's like the countdown.
It's called Countdown. Inspiration 4.
Oh, I saw the fucking. I saw the countdown part. Okay.
But on the 5th episode, it actually has like their fucking cell phone camera footage when they're in space, just fucking chilling, dude.
Oh, nice.
It's fucking because they didn't. Everyone was like, oh, these motherfuckers went to space and we haven't seen any pictures. What the fuck? And I'm like, yeah, because there's a doc series that's airing while it's happening. Shit. You think they're just going to give you all this free shit and not put it in this thing they want you to watch? You fucking idiots.
Yeah.
But holy shit. They had a fucking, the top nose, like they could open it and it was just, or they had one window. It's the biggest window ever in a spacecraft.
Oh, okay.
And it was a dome. And they could just like look out into this dome and you could see the whole fucking planet.
Because they're not, so for windows, it's hard for them to make larger windows from what I've heard. It's hard for them to make the larger windows because of the pressure can put on them and it could break the.
Yeah, because you touched on it a little bit, but this is like you finished the whole series.
Yeah, you actually get to see like the shit that they're seeing and it's fucking, I don't know.
Is there a curve? Is there a curve, brother?
Dude, it's a fucking giant sphere that doesn't even make sense. Like, it's so fucking weird to look at the Earth that way. Like, because it's there, they had like a really nice camera on board too, like a really good one. So
they're not going to send them up there with an Android.
Well, no, everybody had first off, every motherfucker on there had iPhones. So. All you Android people, they're not taking androids to fucking space.
Oh, idiot. Imagine the whole look of the Earth through Jason Bay's phone.
God, dude.
Looking like a fucking CCTV footage from a 7-Eleven in the 90s.
Could you imagine Dane? Could you imagine Dane sending us a picture from space to our iPhone, but it comes in as that little tiny thing, and you're like, bro, That's cool, I guess, man, but...
And it's all... Dude, and...
So stupid.
And that's anyway. That's on 5G.
Anyway.
Fuck 5G at all. That shit don't work.
It's higher than 4, so...
Oh, I just got mad at it today, so it's a, it's a trigger and point.
And it's on 8G.
We love you, Jason and Dane.
But Android
I'm just
sucks.
Saying... Like high resolution video of Earth from the they're farther than the space station, so they're getting like even more fucking like
more view.
Yeah, so it's I was like the whole fucking time I'm just like there's just like tears rolling down my face. I'm like, this is fucking like the most beautiful, incredible thing I've ever seen. Holy shit, they just sent four people. Just fucking four people in a fucking in this capsule in space that's constantly falling to Earth, but their momentum they're like trying yeah,
they boost it back up. Dude,
as exciting as it is,
wild.
That's how Aliens starts.
What, xenomorphs?
It looks fake.
Because it is, bro. No, just kidding.
Don't say that, dude. Don't say that, because all the flat earthers are going to be like, I told you so.
It's just hard not, because how many people have actually fucking seen that, for one? You know, like, the amount of people, I think it said, like, 600 people have been in space.
We're so microscopic to the actual crust of the Earth, like, that's why it's the way it looks.
Like, so, I've always been a pretty, like... I've had a lot of interest in space most of my life. Like, I have a whole sleeve... planned out for my arm of like space, like
just want to be up there floating around by yourself
because it's fucking cool. Nobody as shit. It's just cool. It's really fucking interesting. He wants cool to learn how probably to... fake.
No, why do you keep you like?
Because nothing's real. Like it's really hard for me to believe in the simulation and space at the same time. Unless
you get the worst pep talks.
I know. It's just I'm trying really hard to believe in the simulation.
Touch me, probably fake. Like,
it's all well, great, fucking, man. It made me emotional. I mean, it's not real, but
fucking.
That it's just what keeps me from getting too emotional.
Attached to things. Oh, that's why I'm not gonna say that. Never mind.
Yeah, that's why. Home
Slice says space is amazing and it is terrifying. Amazing
and terrifying, and what? So all of it. Today, randomly, just stoned and thinking, I'm like, how the fuck did they get to the moon in 1960 fucking, what was it, 69 or whatever? Like, how the fuck did these motherfuckers get to the goddamn moon? And when I'm watching all the tech involved in this one, where this thing's flying itself, they're not doing a fucking thing.
Yeah.
They're strapped into this suit.
Nazi rocket scientists.
Holy shit, we're gonna fucking go into space. We might die right now. Like, because the danger is in leaving the planet and coming back into the planet.
And once you're out there, it just kind of vibes.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're probably good. But when you're coming back in the 60s, they're just like, yeah, we think we could probably fucking... You guys got that tin from that shed left over? We'll just throw it around this thing.
They did math and propulsion, and then it just happened, man.
So, like, it seems like everyone was an idiot back then. My dad was around back then.
Your dad is not every human, dude.
I know, but, like...
At that time era.
His old... His... Anybody...
Well, my fucking point of reference is my father, so everybody must have been idiots.
Yeah, but a lot of them were dumb and didn't know shit about shit.
But more than that, more than those dumb people, there's all these smart people that fucking got together with the Nazis and made rockets.
That's true. Once you get the Nazis involved, you're gonna...
Yeah, you're gonna go places.
You're gonna get shit ton, I guess.
You defeat a fucking enemy army, and then...
We don't know how it works, Matt. You tell us.
Yeah, you defeat the enemy army, and then you enslave their fucking smartest people, and then a guy that knows how to draw a mouse makes a whole fucking industry of fucking theme parks, right? Like, isn't that how it works?
I guess so.
Wait a second.
And now we can watch Endgame.
And now we have Space Mountain.
Space Mountain? Do you get it, Dylan? It's a...
What if Space Mountain was all a ruse and we're actually... We go on that ride and we're actually in space.
Yeah.
Because you ever think about that, Dylan?
Yeah.
Do you ever honestly, think that? I've been getting so high lately that I don't even know what to think about shit sometimes. I get in some weird thoughts where I'm like, I don't know if this is things that that people think about. And I'm afraid to even send this one in the group text.
I hear.
I send some weird shit in the group text sometimes. My 6 a.m. random fucking, hey guys, you ever think about fucking, you know, and I'll send some crazy shit and then Jason Bay is the only one awake to react to it.
Yeah.
And then Matt doesn't ever read it, so he doesn't even know. Matt probably doesn't even know about the weird shit I say in the group chat at 6 a.m.
No, but I'm usually chatting with fucking Mikey in the group chat at like 4 a.m. And Mikey close that place out.
There's an hour gap. There's an hour gap from you and Mikey. Well, Mikey goes on a rant for a while before you get involved. It's like
hammered.
And there's an apology in the middle. Sorry, I'm fucking seltzered up.
I had a
bunch
of seltzers in me.
Yeah. And then Matt responds he's probably like, somebody's got to say something.
No, this
Matt
is what happens. Mikey's drunk partying in the fucking group chat having a conversation with himself. I get off fucking Twitch streams late and then I like read back. I actually scroll up for some reason because there's only one person talking. Like, that's easy.
It's just one color bubbles.
Yeah, it's the same profile pic and everything. So I'm just like, I'll get in on this. And then we have a nice chat, and then I go to bed, and then you guys start like six hours of fucking craziness with five people.
Yeah, it gets fucking wild in there because I'll have some random thought, and then I'll throw it out there, and then I'll have a conversation with myself for a while. But then I'll be scrolling and like finding other shit, and then I'll like quadruple send before anyone says anything. So I have like eight different ideas going on before anybody says fucking anything.
Yours goes so fast. Like I'm not, it's all blip,
blip. They have an in spurts.
And I'm like, I'm just here for the ride, man.
Dylan, all of those feely thoughts you're getting mixed with substances and smokables and all that stuff, it just seems to get stronger with age, man. Like you'll notice you're just watching some old movie you've seen 1,000 times and you're like,
what
the fuck.
It's wisdom and empathy.
Watching something that has no feels whatsoever, and I'll just be laying in bed watching it. I'm like, I get that feeling like in your heart and your chest where like it's like that's where like the tears are gonna come from. Like I'm just like, what?
Rewind to a previous statement. Dudes in 1969 were not talking about how things make them fucking cry. You know what I'm saying? Like those fucking idiots pretend
they were complaining about how their wives cried.
I've never cried in my life. You know, those fucking idiot boomers. Like, so, you know, I'm just saying it's a different time, and the fact that all of us can admit to crying during emotional times is
fucking weak leaking.
Nah, man. Yeah, dude, you just gotta piss out that weakness out of your fucking eye dicks. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
No, man. Like, smoking weed again has opened up my empathy. And it's stupid because I used to like being drunk and mad at things. But now I'll just
way fun to be high and laughing at things.
But no, I'll smoke weed and I'll get hammered. And then I'm just like holding Bishop's fucking face. I'm like, we did it, buddy. We're fucking... Oh, I struggle so much so you're happy. Like, and he's just sitting there with his big, dumb fucking face.
He's like, what are you eating, though?
What are you eating, though? It's just he's what like, happens,
you got
man.
Something to eat? Can I get one of those fucking puppuccinos, bro?
If you give him a puppuccino, he'll fucking freak out for the next... He'll love you forever. He'll kill somebody for you. I literally think he would kill somebody for a puppuccino. Nah.
If I didn't think that my cat would fight your dog, I would say to just have Bishop come over for the podcast night.
Actually, back at the old place, there was a cat that would climb up my stairs and scratch at the door. Because my lower stairs neighbors for a long time were Mark and Deus, and they would cook rad curry foods, and it would rise up, so it made it smell.
They were little handsome men.
Yeah, they actually were. They only had sleeping bags and laptops and really great food, but like the smell of all their curryness would like go up. So the cat would fucking scratch, and this cat was homeless as shit, and it was like for 2 weeks. I finally got it
inside.
Give
him an NFHC shirt.
I finally got it, and I brought it inside. I was like, oh, like, are we going to be cool? And Bishop was lovely to it. My giant 98-pound dog was lovely to it, but that cat fucked his face up.
Yeah, it's not your dog I'm worried about. My cat, anytime a dog has ever shown up, she's like, the fuck are you doing here? And she just beats the fuck out of him real quick, and they're like,
what'd she do?
I don't even know you.
Did she, I guess, well, I mean, what'd she do with Pokey?
Beat the fuck out of him.
Beat the fuck out of him?
For a little while, she was cool most of the time, but if he ever got close, she's like, bitch, like, get the fuck out of here, you stupid cat. Like, she don't fuck around.
Oh, the last. I
still can't believe that cunt face fucking let his dog out and lost.
The last episode we did at Dylan's house, the second episode we did there and the last one, though, I believe I showed the entirety of YouTube and the Discord Pokey's asshole on accident because I was just holding him. And I like spun around because he's a little dog.
Yep. So, yeah. No consent.
No. Fuck, why'd you gotta make it weird?
You put my asshole on the internet and you didn't give me any money or have my consent.
Hey, that's a lawsuit, brother.
Only pause. Better lawyer up. Yeah.
Lawyer up. Lawyer up, dog.
Lawyer up!
I wish we could have showed Jay's asshole when it was all pinched from the clippers.
Yeah, the pinch clipper fucking.
Can we hold Jay's tail up and fucking put his asshole up to the camera and.
Where'd you... I hold a microphone to it and look into a camera like, where'd you nick your wrinkle?
It's the one that doesn't stinks. Look like a... It's the scar that doesn't look like a wrinkle.
Oh, there's a bent spoke on this wheel.
The Scarlet Bros asshole.
Dude, yeah. The bent spoke, that's your fucking shit, your shitty dive bar that we're going to open in our 60s. The bent spoke.
We might get sued by that company Bespoke.
No, bent spoke.
We're not selling like knives and cologne.
No, we cut his asshole.
Pictures of my cut asshole. Totally different thing.
Well, shit.
Yeah, we can't get knives to work with this fucking deal, so it's just buttholes. Hey, real quick. I forgot. I'm going to throw this note out.
Read
real quick.
Notes.
Oh, yeah, Jay's got
Jay notes. Made,
yeah,
I'm going to read note real
a,
quick.
Jay it's made just quick. A note.
The first part I don't get, so you're going to have tons of questions. I don't have answers. I'm just going to tell you that right now. I had a dream, and during that dream, the dream was... like something, it was like weird, like I was driving with I think maybe my family or something, but we were like getting away from something.
Yeah.
And as I'm driving, and it's like down
libs.
It was down like PCH highway. Yes. So I'm driving with, I think it was like PCH highway because the ocean was off to my left.
Yeah. They're like T-1000.
And there's no there was nothing around. It was just something was going on. I don't know what it was. I couldn't tell you what was around anything other than a road and an ocean. And as I'm going down the road, there's a man and two girls. And as I get closer, hot. It's a fat Chris D'Elia.
Aww.
And like a wife beater.
That comedian. Fat.
I don't know why he was in my dream, but as I drive by, I go, "You're fucking fat." And then I just keep going. And I see him, like, he gets pissed and he starts chase. And after that, I don't remember. I just remember that part of my
dream. Yeah, and his arms turn into, like, metal fucking machetes, right?
No, didn't happen.
God damn
it. I have nothing for you. That's all I remember this. There's a building, like a gas station we were hiding in from something. Like, it's just, but I remember very clearly. Hopefully fat Chris D'Elia. And me calling him fat.
How old were the two girls that were with him?
I don't know. They were probably underage.
Actually, so what's on the Chris D'Elia
tip.
So I guess most of that stuff came out that there wasn't really any underage.
No, he was a pedophile and workaholics, dude.
Yeah. So he's been doing his podcast and shit again.
Yeah. I just don't think he's funny.
He's like slowly like hey, did you guys forget about this yet? And I think everyone's just like, yeah, I don't know. Whatever, man. Just do your thing.
That's how it all goes with that.
So last night on my way home from hanging with you fucking hung dudes.
Yeah.
I was at Bell and El Mirage waiting at the light, and I'm the first vehicle crosswalk in front of me.
The Mirage.
Yes. A gentleman is coming across the crosswalk, and I just kind of see him, and I'm listening to, I was listening to your music or a podcast. I don't remember. Sitting there, and he's walking, and I see him, he's got his head down. He's like going through his phone. He gets in front of me, and my lights hit him. He's got a rake in his hand, and he's walking off to the middle of nowhere, because north of Bell and El Mirage is desert. Just desert.
Yeah, it's just ain't shit out there.
When I lived out there, that's where the cartel would throw severed heads.
Yeah, and that's where he's headed. And he's dressed like...
Beheaded.
He's dressed like fucking Everlast.
What? He's got the little shitty fucking Grannis chin beard?
He's got a hat. He had camo. He had camo pants on, and one leg was pulled up. It was just weird. He had a rake in his hand.
The fuck?
Like, not the big fan out ones, but the small metal ones. Ugh. Just walking out to the middle of the desert.
Dude, I lived out there for years, and there was an 8-week time frame where seven of those weeks they found several different people's severed heads. No bodies ever.
Yeah, it's the homeless under that bridge as you're going west.
They just have their tits out.
On Bell Road. On Bell Road, yeah. It's a bridge. It's a wash underneath and where they used to mine and get like minerals out of. Yeah. And it's like Skid Row underneath there. There's homeless people that just live under there. You see them walking and going down there. As you pass, you can look down and you see all their wares and their homes, and like, it's crazy. But he didn't look like he looked put together and just had the rake. And I was like, I was looking down where there's a road, but it's still dark, no lights. And I was looking down to see if like, maybe he was driving and the rake, hold on. Maybe he was driving and like the rake flew out or something. There was no vehicle. He was just walking out to nowhere.
You know what it was?
What's that?
NPC.
NPC.
That's a non-playable character, dude.
Oh, in like an open world game.
Yeah, if you would have went and talked to that guy, he would have had like six things to say, and then he would have tried to talk to him again. He'd be like, "Howdy, sir, what can I do for you tonight?" You're like, "Bro, we've been talking for like 5 minutes."
Yeah.
Oh, it's a nice night we're having, huh? You're like, "Bro, what's happening right now?"
The random non-story, non-characters in a fucking like Grand Theft Auto game, just the people walking.
They're just like appearing walking off into the forest.
Yeah.
Listen, okay.
Because it's a simulation.
I love the whole... So space was cool and shit, but back to the shit's not really real.
Yeah.
There are so many NPCs throughout our lives all the time. It's kind of weird if you think about it. I don't know. There's just a lot of people that after you have a conversation with them, you're like, this felt like it... There was so little substance in any of it. You're like, it felt like that dude was just here to fucking make this game last a little longer.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, and why it was did like, I, what the fuck was that?
And it was like 7:30 at night. It's completely dark at this point.
He might have had a quest.
Yeah.
He was prepared. Apparently his phone was charged. He had headphones in. He was ready for whatever lawn he came across.
Like, you walk up and he's like, "Hey, stranger, I seem to have lost some gardening tools. If you find all 15 of my gardening tools,
I'm looking for us. I'm looking for a bag of leaves I seem to have lost.
I need 7 bags of leaves." Yeah. Oh, yeah, you gotta collect.
I can't help you until you bring me 7 bags of leaves.
Did he have an exclamation point over his
head? Or a light or like a glow to him?
No. I mean, he was lit up by my headlights.
This game fucking sucks.
This game fucking sucks.
Yeah, it is. It's weird. That's what caused me. That's when I was like, I asked Siri to make note.
Siri, please make note.
The last the last portion of my note, and I've already brought this up, part of it, but things just keep happening. Like, the bathroom at my work is just it's filled with mystery. Lots of mystery.
Let me unlock your secrets.
So the toilet once again has shit all over the front of it. A puddle of fluid was found again on the top shelf inside the fucking stall. Where is that coming? Why is that up there? How is the shit getting on the bottom, like the bell of the bowl? Like, not on, like, even if it was on the front, like, okay, maybe you're pulling your pants down. You're like, I'm not sitting as this comes out. But it's down. I don't get it. And a couple days ago, I go in there to take a piss in the urinal, and it's like the beginning of the day.
Yeah.
Somebody decided to stand in front of the urinal and not use it at all because it was all over the floor. A lot of it.
Isn't there?
Wasn't water. It's a nice building. It's a nice area. Like, it's Scottsdale. It's by Fashion Square. Like, it's nice. No piss.
Is it a shared complex with multiple businesses?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Because I was like, there's like, 12 people that work with you?
It makes sense. It's like one giant porta potty because there's a construction company in there.
That's
because I know, but why is my question? I know where now.
Those people inside?
Because I go in there and I see fucking Red Wings sticking out from underneath the stalls, you know? So I know it's the construction guys and a wicker hat hanging off the corner. So I know it's the construction guys, but it's not who. I know somewhat who, but why was that? Like, you know what? I'm just going to stand in front of it, and I feel like they just did this. And they're like, wherever it goes, it goes.
I've disrespected a bathroom in my youth.
Jay.
Today. So,
look in the Discord. Hold on. Okay, good.
Today, there was one drop about this big of piss on top of the urinal.
Somebody's just going in there and just leaning back and going.
A little dribble, like this much of piss. A little dribble, this much of piss.
He's a construction worker. He's dehydrated.
On top of the urinal, like the top shelf where the handle is. On top. Why? How? In just one, like, you're like, and then squeeze real quick.
So, these are the people that are using restrooms. This is in a porta potty. I was on a construction site again today for the first time in a while, real construction site. And if you're not on youtube.com/NFHC podcast, this is what the porta john today says. So what it originally says is Trump for 2024. That's it. Up the ass like your mother. My name is Jeff.
Dad?
Me off. Dad? But then somebody crossed out 2024 and just made it say 420, which is kind of funny. I don't know. Like, it's just a bunch of weird shit going on, but this is like none of it makes any sense. So yeah, they're just thinking these thoughts and just pissing straight up in the air, dude, because they're fucking complete moron idiots.
Yeah, and I get that. I get, like, yeah, the shitty mess, like, they treat it like a porta potty, okay?
It's a shitty mess.
And then I've ran across some individuals that are suspect that aren't part of the construction company that's in there. There's a law office.
It's your boss.
There's fancy stuff. I work with broads.
Oh.
So I don't, so on my end, no. But
that's the perfect fucking cover, though. They could just go in there and blast their fucking.
But I get, like, writing nasty stuff. That's just like delinquent, like, ugh, fucking idiot. But, like, it's a special kind of, like, psychopath to leave this much piss on top of a urinal.
The people that write in these things, they take wads of toilet paper and they shove them in the piss part of the urinal so that it fills up, so it's just a soup of everyone's piss.
I get it. That's an easy
task. What the hell
is
wrong with these people, though?
I know.
I like, why?
It is. That's childish behavior. Look, it's this much piss on top
an inch.
Dylan, I get that. You can wad it up, you can do that. But for one, it's skill based.
It's the same thing, though. It's a
skill
same
level,
thing.
Though. There's no skill level in wadding up toilet paper, skill plugging something, filling it with piss.
A fucking bathroom.
Writing shit on the wall. No skill based. To manage to leave this much of, like, droplet of piss, like, it's not a splash. Like,
how much piss was it?
Yeah, Nick, like, this much piss.
Okay.
It was this much piss. Like that long. Like it wasn't like a
thimble
drop.
Of, like a thimble of piss.
A yeah. Of piss. It was a microscopic chalice of urine.
So like if a fucking hamster was getting hammered on piss.
Yeah, like if a it was like if a mouse ran across and decided to stop and have a piss real quick.
He's like, oh, you guys are drinking piss? Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, let me go get my cup. But nowhere else on top. You know, a regular urinal, dude. A regular urinal with the fucking, it's got the hardware coming out.
The wall mount.
Regular. You got, and it's about chest level, right?
Hold on.
Chest.
Keep talking.
Yeah, it's about chest level. And you have your shelving in front of you. This one in particular seems a lot higher. Like I'm pretty close to like head on rim when I take a piss on this one. There's no other droplets around it. You know what I mean? It was just this, and I'm like, how? How is just that?
It's that person planted a seed in your brain, and now you're gonna have an aneurysm in like 2 years.
And then the one inside, right, for the second time where the Jake. it's the toilet paper.
Show me on the urinal where the piss was.
Okay.
Oh God.
I can't show you. Okay, so on the right side next to the fixture. Okay. See the little so you have the flush handle.
The water. Yeah.
Follow the pipe down.
Yeah.
And then directly to the right on this shelf.
Of the base of the metal.
Yeah, right to the right on the top.
Boop.
Okay. So they've pissed to the top deck of they're like the fucking nosebleeds.
Yeah.
The nosebleeds. It's like
they got piss on the roof.
Bro, why are you getting piss on the roof, man?
Just one. Am I crazy? That seems so out of
it got like, in your mind, dude, for sure.
It's things like this. Apparently, like,
definitely like, did it to you. Yeah,
it's just it blows my mind. Like I'm playing piss detective. You know, like I want to go in there and be like, ah, what are you doing? You know, like especially and even the one inside the stall. It's not so the little shelf that I'm talking about inside the stall. It's just the fixture for the toilet paper. So it's not like a full shelf. It's not big enough to set a drink
like
on.
2 inches, like a 2 inch little.
And
lift.
If you bring a drink into the shitter with you, you're fucking.
That's pretty weird.
You're fucking gross.
Home slice said, anthropomorphic. I can't even say it. Anthropomorphize it. Yeah. It's on the shoulder of the urinal.
There you go. Yeah.
Oh, man.
It's a little Biden whisper on the shoulder of the urinal.
It's a little pisper.
Yeah. A little pisper. God damn it. I'll write it down.
That's your best one yet, Dylan.
The weed's just right at a nice spot. And the coffee.
Yeah.
Weed and coffee's mingling well.
Yeah.
Well, it's fucking... So, I don't know, man.
I don't know, man.
Whoa. That's what I said. That's what I said, bro.
Yeah, it's a pistery.
I just have...
It's a modern-day pistery?
Dude, you need to get a... Matt, okay.
Fucking Scooby Doo Doo mystery.
Dude, I was about to say, Matt needs to Photoshop the pistry machine.
Yeah.
The pistry machine.
And then just stick it on the door of the bathroom. And just call it the pistry machine.
Scooby Doo Doo Doo.
The pistry. God damn it.
That's good stuff.
Spell check is just ruining me typing this quick.
Like, what's their... Why is there piss up on the urinal, Scooter?
All our episodes have so many fake words in the titles that every time I'm, like, uploading shit, it's like, are you sure that's what you're trying to fucking say, dude? Like, yeah,
like, how they get the poop on the front of the bowl, Scoops.
I seriously have never understood why people would want to make the place... Like, I hate using a fucked up bathroom more than anything.
That's why people leave it a mess.
But, like, they had to use it first to, like, make it a mess. And, like, they probably didn't want it. Because
it was clean for them.
And I are fucking idiots, man. That's why when, like, people are out in space looking at the planet, like, man, they're all fucking idiots down there shitting on the front of the bowl.
I accidentally painted a fucking... the wall of a Whataburger when I had to go so bad. I didn't have no time to sit, Dylan.
Yeah, but that would make sense. Like, if I came in and the shit was against the wall, I'd be like, I get it. Pants came down, shit on the wall. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And, like... apparently, they don't clean the toilet every day.
Okay, Jay, hear me out. What if? Okay, so you know when sometimes
Dylan's
you get a little
what
fucking,
if?
That'd be a good segment. Because, dude, we should make a segment of my 6 a.m. You guys ever think about? So what if somebody comes in, and it's like their first pisser of the day, and they fucking jerked it that morning, but they didn't get all the fucking... all the little excess out of the tip, and right when they start pissing, one just fucking up high, right on the shoulder of the urinal.
The evidence doesn't point to that.
No, what's the splash? What's the splash angle?
I'm telling you that the fucking the where the pisper happened. It was like I should have taken a picture. If I would have had my phone on, I should have taken a picture. Like, if I showed you, you would be as befuddled as I.
Oh. Like, okay, so is it like...
It's enough for me to bring it up. Like, I'm. It's enough for me to have brought it to the show because I can't figure out... I've pissed in a lot of places. I've had accidental piss sprays a lot of times.
It's literally...
I got pisses.
I have 42 years of piss experience. Okay? I consider myself a pro.
It's a person bored at work that just has a degenerate mind fucking with you.
Yeah. It's like...
it's one of them broads just fucking...
It's as if... It's as if the pipes had a leak, but once... But once. You know what I mean? And it was yellow, and it was definitely piss. So I don't get it.
What color yellow was it?
Coffee.
Oh. It was definitely a construction worker.
Yeah, they definitely had
coffee. Yeah.
Like, because those dudes don't drink water at all.
It wasn't mine, because when I take my morning piss, it's vitamins, so it just looks like straight Gatorade.
I can send you some piss bottles from my old work site.
Seen them.
And we can test that. We can see how sick that guy is.
I need... What is that noise? Did you hear that? Screeching. Get one of those fucking drug test strips. I'll just dip it in there. If it's meth and Buchweiser, then it's construction
meth
worker.
Meth and Buchweiser?
Buchweiser.
Buchweiser.
It's definitely Home just Slice. Somebody that doesn't give a fuck, and they're just...
Home Slice said, hear me out. This maniac took a wad of toilet paper, pissed in it, and then wrung it out onto the shoulder of the urinal specifically to fuck with you.
Yeah.
Dude, it would have had to have been one quick piss in the rag.
That's his experience. He rang it out?
See? And that right there is even more of a psychopath to take the time to do that.
Yeah, they're doing it to you, man. You need to get a camera.
Next time, I'm gonna bring my phone every time I go to take a piss, and I'm gonna start taking pictures of these random acts.
Yes,
of
we're gonna make a flip book, a calendar. And we could make a 2021 calendar.
And you know, the other thing 22. Is too, like, I've lost my comfortability that I had at my old job, because it was just one shitter, and like you had your own space. This one, it's three. You have the handicap, two small ones. The small ones are like Because when you take a shit, you don't put your legs together and like sit like proper. Like your legs are spread and you're like, you know, like this. This is how I sit when I shit.
You're cranking them? You're really rocking it out of your fucking corpse.
No, I'm getting a good angle of my for my intestines to shit right. I look like Conan at the end of The Barbarian when he's sitting on his throne. I'm like...
You have a tactical shit maneuver, dude. What?
I do. You never know when I have to fucking dive on somebody.
I'm relaxed. Hope Slice said you shit like Captain Morgan.
Everybody's got their own. Yeah.
You shit like Captain.
Everybody's got their shit stature. So it's not about how I sit. It's your legs.
Scrolling Facebook.
It's your legs. You don't. Your legs aren't together like you're wearing a skirt. You're at a wide berth, you know what I mean? So these stalls are so thin, like today, all three of them. I'm in the middle, guy on my left and my right. Guy on the right, my back is handicapped.
Together.
The one next to me, you're like, our shoes were like fucking 2 inches away from each other. Very uncomfortable situation while you're pooping. You know what I mean? Like, how would you feel if, like, you're taking a shit and all of a sudden a shoe touches you?
That's how that one dude got.
That's a sign. That's intentional.
I know.
You want to poop and then get your dick sucked?
I know the ramifications.
It's a lot of outs that
of a toe tap in the shitter.
Yeah, he's just he's cleared it out, letting you know he's ready.
Yeah.
The cargo hold has been.
He's like,
and. God,
he's like, listen to me
forever.
Empty this tunnel out for your dick, bro. Like,
look,
let's go.
Look, everybody also has however they wipe. Some go front, some go back, some wad, some roll, all this stuff.
Put bro, your this hands guy, in the air.
This guy, the guy next to me, I hear him stand up to fucking wipe. And like, I don't, maybe it's just me, but after your first wipe, do you scrub your asshole?
Wait, what do you mean by scrub my asshole?
Just answer the question.
I don't think is I've it ever a, scrubbed is it a wipe? My asshole with a, during a wipe.
Okay, so this is what I hear next to me on the first wipe. And I'm sitting there, I'm like, he just... That was the first wipe, and you just... I mean, I've never scrubbed my
He's
asshole.
Grinding it into his fucking creases, dude.
Dude...
All his nooks and crannies are full of himself now.
You know the sound when you like when you clean your shoe with the brush? That's what it sounded like. I'm
you
like,
do that at the bitter end. Like
I don't ever do that. Like I have a method, but I've never
Yeah, no, never that.
Okay, so like this well,
I'm
is
just saying if you were
question.
To do that at the end.
Yeah, it'd be at the end. First. It'd be in the shower.
We've probably
with
I know,
a loofah.
I know we've discussed this before, probably, but I just don't remember because, you know, this is 201. Mm-hmm. Get fucked. Get a problem with it. Are you guys, like, folders or crumplers?
Folders. It depends. Depends on how
it's
the...
It's always a folder, bro.
It depends on how it's given to me. I like a lot of toilet paper in a public...
That's bad for the plumbing.
No, listen. In a public setting, in a public restaurant... Or anywhere public, they
it's
have
still
the
plumbing.
Listen, they have the high fingers. The HC toilet, whatever, where it's like the it sucks it down. So I'm like as much TP as it takes, dude, because I'm not home with my wet wipes, so I got to make sure that asshole's clean,
dude. Wipes,
at home,
dude wipes.
At home, yeah. At home, it's two fucking wet wipes and then a fucking a small bit to dry off the moisture.
Oh man,
yeah.
So, speaking of toilets, it's just like kind of off topic. I was at work the other day.
Yeah.
Speaking of toilets and construction workers, I just am casually doing my thing. They're talking loud enough, just fucking around, you know, having a dumb conversation that I can hear everything they're saying. And it's a small. The site I'm working on mostly is pretty small, and like everybody just kind of talks shit all day, fucks around. The power, so they remodeled part of this building and they cut off a section of it so that they can rent that space out to somebody else.
Yeah.
So they disconnected all the electric on that site, but that's where the toilets that we were allowed to use are. And the bathrooms are still open. You can get to them, but there's no power. So the lights are, it's like black in that motherfucker. So you got a cell phone light that shit. So if you're taking a shit, if you walk in and take a piss, you know someone's taking a shit because you can see their little cell phone light through the stall. It's funny as shit. But, so toilets don't require electricity.
No.
It's pretty common knowledge. If you're a construction worker, you should fucking kind of know that, I guess. I don't know. But I hear, just hear, one guy's like, yeah, man, I went in there and I fucking, there's no lights on, but I did a quick test on the toilet and those things are still flushing.
Wait,
man.
What? No.
Like, it's like, is this guy fucking for real right now? This is not how
toilets work.
It's
a water
work.
Pressure gravity thing. Fucking, oh no.
And wow. Then 5 minutes later, a different dude goes, man, this thing's smoother than a baby's asshole. I'm like, that's not the phrase, dude. Like, what? Are you guys all fucking complete morons in this place?
Fuck, dude.
What's happening over here?
You got some guys on a list at your fucking job.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
That's bad.
That's not a good look, but he's saying it to another man in a men's restroom, so.
Well, no, this was just out in the open.
Oh, that's even worse. Just
it would have been worse if the guy's like, yeah, I know what you mean.
Well, like, it was probably.
God damn it.
It was either.
Call the authorities.
Sharp as a whistle type situation where he just didn't know the right. Oh,
brass balls of steel kind of play.
Or it's his own. I'm just being funny, making fun of the normal phrase. I know I'm saying it wrong. Or most likely, he's a fucking idiot.
Probably that one.
I'm going with the third one.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Don't know how the toilets work.
Man, there was no power in there, but I did the toilet test. Holy shit, the oven didn't turn on, but I reset the router. Like, what the fuck?
The toilets are flushing. Come charge your phone.
So there's another set of bathrooms in this building.
Oh my
God. I think I sent it in our group chat.
Yeah.
That the people that still work there use, and the construction workers were using. And this bathroom's like fucking nice. Like, it's always clean. There's air conditioning in it. Like, when you go in there, you're like, holy fuck, man. And there's like a little shower area in the back. Like, it's a really fucking well-kept bathroom.
Matt's over potty talk.
Construction workers were in there blowing that fucking thing up. And all these like dudes that work on like real like crazy space electronics are like, man, they put a sign on the door that's like, no construction workers use this bathroom.
Because they'll piss on the top of it because they don't even care. Because
they'll piss on the shoulder of the stall. They segregated the bathrooms.
Jay, we used to know people that would like paint pictures with their piss. You could just picture one dude just being like, bloop, and finish
off. You gotta, I'm telling you, you don't fucking understand. You can speculate all day long, but next time there's gonna be a picture.
Yep. There's a spec.
I'm losing my mind over it.
Fucking prove it. Let's head to break real quick.
And that's been potty talk.
It was a time. We'll be right back.
Promo code NFHC.
Everybody, welcome back to the show. So you're gonna notice something a little bit different. Normally we have Walter's Wall of Whoa playing in between the break, but this week, for now, Walter's got some things going on, so the Walter's Wall of Woe is going to take a short break, but we're not going to forget about him. He's still
canceled from us. It's a suspension. They didn't completely cancel him, but they put him on a suspension for having us on. So yeah. Sorry, so, Walt.
We will have all of that back. So any of you that might panic because you didn't hear it, don't. We'll be just fine.
We don't use that term here,
Jay. Yeah, sorry. And Walter is good. Everything is good, so don't worry about him.
I could gawk him right now if I wanted to.
Yeah. So
I've got plans for Walter possibly, but we'll talk about those.
Yeah, Walter. Trust me, Walter ain't fucking going anywhere. even if he wanted to.
I am gonna try to get his back walls of woe up on the YouTube pretty soon here.
So
Bill in the chat says he got suspended for letting Limp Bizkit play. Because of fucking villain.
Sorry, dude. Yeah, I didn't. Well, when a band is so hot, everybody's looking for a reason to fuck. Hey, you can't. That's ours. We own that property, and you cannot play it. And that's what happened right there. Fucking Limp Bizkit's just too hot for internet radio.
That new Limp Bizkit track I really like. Sorry.
La-di-da. Well, Walt, we love you. And we'll talk to you about some stuff.
Are you guys
later.
Fucking done?
Yeah. Not about Walt. Walt's never over. Yeah.
Get your
fucking. All right, so in beta testing of the podcast, we want to thank everyone who's participating in our open beta. we're working out the bugs. If you have any things that you want to suggest that you would like to see or have, like, we're actually considering to do things that you want us to do this time. You know, all those other times when you like, you guys should do this, and we're like, yeah, and then we never do it. this time it's going to be different. Like, I've changed. We've changed.
Dylan hit another level of existence recently.
We've grown lately, everyone, and we're sorry for the way that we treated you before.
Yeah.
We won't do it again. We'll never hit you that hard.
We'll never hit you as hard as I can.
You got to understand, though, it's Dylan behind the scenes going, well, if I want to do it. So now it's we're going to try things.
I'm going to try to get help.
Instead of it being Dylan, let me fucking, let me vet this shit real quick.
Well, I'm still going to do that. If your idea sucks, your idea sucks. I don't know what to tell you. I can't.
But we're still going to try it.
They can't all be winners. We could try it. We're beta testing everything.
That will be content within itself.
We're trying to fix the audio so that you hear when, like, Jay's to the left and I'm to the right. You know, like, we're working on the things. You don't want to have Jay coming up on your right and you hear him on the left and then you got fucking, you know, it's not good stuff. We're fixing the bugs. The graphics are going to get better. You know, like, we're trying. But
that wasn't supposed to happen right there. See?
See, it's...
Shit's misfiring.
Man, I need to remember that fucking happened. anyway, so... segue out of that. The first beta test bit this week.
No theme song yet.
It has the theme song built in.
It's shit! This is a visual thing.
This is the pilot. So, understand that as this grows... it'll get better. Not much, probably, because it kind of like has like a special little feel to it. How it kind of doesn't look as good as it could, but this is kind of part of it. It's the pilot. We're trying it out.
Yeah, you got to pitch it. You got to pitch it to the studio, the higher up.
Home Slice is nervous about this.
Oh,
he said so earlier. He didn't want anyone to know that, and I just, you know, I'm sorry.
You threw him under the fucking bus.
I know you didn't want everyone to know that you're a little nervous, but like he's, you know, he put time into this, and we put time into this, and we edited, and like this is a labor of love right here.
And I was there,
and Jay was there playing Splitgate.
Yeah, I played Split. You know, I helped with your search by telling you to look up certain things.
That's
you're
true.
Like, see.
Honestly, I had way more fun editing a video with people hanging out than I did doing it by myself. So I'm probably gonna start doing that in Discord a lot more.
There was a point where Dylan forgot that he needed to do a thing because he was so stoned that he was just playing with his mouse pointer.
Well, I got super high and somebody was telling a story, like a really good story. And I was streaming my video and it's just me like moving my mouse left and right on the screen. Like not doing anything for at least 10 minutes, like just listening. It was a great time. I was having... it was a really good fucking day, but this is the result of...
Without further ado...
random conversations in Discord.
Yeah.
YouTube.com/... or YouTube.com/C/NFHC podcast. It's fucking YouTube.
This is NFHC Studios original.
What's up, boys? This is Loads of Knowledge with Home Slice, new segment for the NFHC podcast. Now, I'm just here to tell you a bunch of bullshit that I happen to know. So, you know, I'm going to solve this puzzle while I do it, and hopefully you enjoy. So, first off, everybody know who Mary Shelley is? If you don't, she is the woman who wrote that book, Frankenstein. And so she was a little weird. This woman ended up losing her virginity on her mother's grave. You know, we knew she was kind of tapped. That's the only kind of mind that'll write a book like Frankenstein. But still, a little weird. The other thing is, when Mary Shelley actually married somebody, he ended up passing away before she did. And one of the weird things that she did was keep his corpse. Or not his full corpse, but a piece of it. She actually carried around his heart in a bag for, like, the rest of her life. It was the only piece of him that, that didn't burn when, he was cremated. Well, again, I'm kind of wrong here, too, because, she thought it was his heart. It wasn't his heart. It was actually just his liver, because it wouldn't burn in the fire, and yeah, so she carried this dude's liver around in a bag for the rest of her life after he died, and you know, she ended up writing, well, one of the classics of horror, you know, so I mean, it can't have all been bad, but that brings me to my next fact. It's about the father of modern microbiology. Now, this dude, his name is Antoni von Leeuwenhoek, and he is considered the father of modern microbiology pretty much because he was fucking around with lenses at one point. So this dude took a bunch of flea glass and put together this like microscope, one of the first real microscopes, and he kind of just wanted to see what shit looked like underneath a microscope. So he ended up taking this thing and looking at a cork from, you know, a wine bottle, and with this cork he ended up seeing that, oh shit, there's a whole bunch of you know, really cool honeycomb patterns that are all part of this thing. And with that, he was like, okay, well, maybe everything's made up of tiny little pieces of stuff. So he went outside and he got a bunch of river water, and he put that on a slide and started to take a look at it. And he saw it was like teeming with tiny little life that looked almost like little bugs.
Amoebas
and shit. So dude's like, okay, what are we made out of? How do I figure this out? So what the guy did is he took one of the first microscope slides ever, and he pulled out his dick, and he beat his meat for science. This guy took his jizz and spread it on this slide, and he was 100% expecting to see tiny little humans like owls in his cum that would make it so that you know, life would come about. So you know, he was all about the fact that, you know, it was these tiny little people that were doing it. But turns out he really discovered the smallest cell in the human body, the sperm cell. You know what the largest cell is?
No.
It's the egg. Egg cell. So that was a bunch of knowledge. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll catch you later.
There used to be a lot of incels that hung out. Hey! That's fucking great.
That was awesome.
Home Slice, don't you fucking dare. Don't you dare be nervous.
That was great. That was if I can make one suggestion on Dylan's side.
Yes, sir.
Maybe just on my end, the music was a bit loud.
I couldn't tell when I was making it. I'm like, yeah, it feels like it might be like just right, or too loud, or not loud enough. It was really hard to like fucking
bit more in the background.
Well, but it's a pilot, great. So you know.
I'm shitting on you. It was brilliant. It was great. Just a little note.
And my boy fucking solved the goddamn Rubik's cube.
You can solve the Rubik's Cube.
Like, come on!
And Can I say that staring at Home Slice's face for like that extended period of time, which we don't ever really, he just kind of pops in and out, and it's never like a full screen thing. Because I'm not a creep and click on his video when we're talking and have it pop up and just stare at him.
I mean, you should.
I know. Well, now I know. But his mustache.
He didn't ruin it like I did.
His mustache grows very thick right here in the middle.
So he can get in trouble if he's not careful.
Yeah, yeah. Make sure you never shave the sides, bud.
So, you want to know a fun fact about that video?
What's that?
Yes.
That was like the world premiere of Home Slice having his face in a thing.
Oh.
In like a setting such as this.
He graced us with it, and it's beautiful.
He faced his fears.
Oh.
I don't know if it's a fear. It's just, you know.
Oh.
A fear?
It's just a thing that happened.
I mean, I don't know if I was trying to just tell a joke or not, you know.
Well, I think that I appreciate your input, Jay, and thanks. I will take note of it for the next one. We have funny ideas for it already to continue to grow. If people want to see some more of that,
I do.
So it's kind of a dual, like it's an audio thing for sure, but it's the visual version of it. There's more going on if you're just listening to the podcast.
It's more stats.
I'm gonna put them out separately on YouTube, like on the NFHC studio stuff, like yes. As their own little thing.
Yes.
But yeah, there's like little. He gave me like timestamps and little bits of information that were like coming onto the screen as he's talking. So. I was trying to think of a way for us to like be able to like talk about those, but it's really hard to like, we can't really pause the video and be like read the thing. It doesn't really work out. But in the video form, it's got more going on.
When
it's
like,
but as audio form, you're just getting info. It's great.
Well, yeah, when he was like that one chick lost her virginity on her like dad's grave.
Yeah, nigga.
And it did that. Like that was a good time. Similar sample, but you know.
Yeah.
Same song, isn't it?
Same song. So fucking good job, guys.
Great job, both of you, and Home Slice, you're a fucking handsome.
So Slice individual. Only saw the first half because that's as far as we got, and I finished the second half today. So he hadn't even seen the whole thing, and I added a bunch of I was trying so hard to find little splatters to look like it has come on the screen. And then today, literally my first search, they were the first one. I'm like, what the f-? I've been looking for these for 3 days. And it was just like the very first one that popped up. I'm like, fuck yeah, I got them. I did a bunch of work to get them to look like cum.
I appreciate all you guys, because that was new to me. I didn't see shit. Dylan's like, hey, download this and we'll play it at some point today. I was like, okay, cool. And I just fucking... I closed myself off from the little file. Did not see it.
That right bit now. Was sponsored by manscaped.com. If you go to their website and use promo code NFHC, you'll get 20% off and free shipping.
And so's this next one.
Oh, look at this. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Yeah. Look at that. Would y'all look at that?
Yeah, the second part of the show is always community-based. As of right now. But anyway, people based send community? Us their stuff.
Do we have a based community?
I think we probably a little
I don't bit. Know what that actually means.
It
honestly.
Was cool.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt, but I don't need to learn anything right now. Right, keep going.
Fine. Okay. But yeah, and everybody sends us things every week. NFHCpodcast.com has all the links to send the things. Let's see here. Bonker Size Wonga from the Discord sent us this little jam. We always try to find ones that are, you know, they got the visual, but since it's a lot of people are audio, we try to keep it funny. We try to balance it all, because I understand. It's called Look at This. Podcasts are audio mostly. We get it, but anyway. Bonker Size Wonga. Here we go.
I love the kind of woman that will actually just kill me. You know, when I left the house today, I was thinking, damn, I really hope some hot chick paints my brains all over some fucking hallway.
Is that the dude from Cowboy Bebop? Yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody made new audio.
And here we are. I mean, really just absolutely destroy me. I'm talking...
He's just talking to some chick in a hallway.
I'm talking full-on watermelon in the thighs level carnage. And I wanted to scare the shit out of me.
I mean, I hope I piss myself. I hope I piss myself and you call me
your little pee-pee piss-piss boy. I want you to fuck me up. I mean, I want you to make me your bitch. Your little pee-pee piss-myself bitch. I want it to get embarrassing.
I mean, like, weirdly embarrassing.
Unsanitary, too. We should be entirely different people by the end of the first 8 hours. Do you understand what I'm trying to say here?
I mean, I'm a real freak. I'm not normal, ma'am.
Please, you have to crush me.
Fuck your little pee-pee piss boy bitch.
Have you seen who's going to be playing him for the live action movie?
No, Netflix is making Cowboy Bebop live action, right?
Yeah, it's fucking.
It's the dude from Harold and Kumar.
Yeah, the guy that played fucking Sulu in the newer Star Trek movies.
That's that dude in.
Cowboy I knew your Bebop? Face would do that.
He did not seem thrilled.
No. Mm-mm.
There's like, you can look it up. There's a picture of him, like it's like a promo pic.
I've not seen a lot of it, that but I saw they dropped a trailer of the intro for it. And it's like scene for scene the OG intro, but live action. Like they nailed it. Like it's exactly the same.
I'm cool. So fucking nervous to even try anything Netflix is making because they fucked me on Jupiter's Aww. Circle or whatever, that fucking goddamn...
Jupiter Ascending?
Yeah.
I'll send you the trailer later. No,
Jupiter Ascending's the fucking Wachowski them's new movie or whatever.
Sorry, Jupiter's...
The fucking hero show that had...
Yeah.
Whatever.
Hey, okay, speaking of Jupiter, that just reminds me. Can we talk about something real quick? You know how everybody's like... Elon Musk is like a terrible person or whatever because he's a billionaire and like his chick that he just is getting divorced from, Grimes, the DJ chick.
Yeah.
Everyone's always like, oh my God, why is this person with such a terrible person? Mm-hmm. But in their divorce, she said that she is taking one of Jupiter's moons to build a lesbian cult.
They're perfect.
So can we just like, can we just admit that they're both fucking insane and not just like, come on now.
What do you what do you think of that Elon Musk is going to, he has a contract with the U.S. government to deliver weapons around the globe in 1 hour?
Who fucking cares, man? he probably won't.
Oh, there's crazy shit going on in the world.
It's a seven.
I'm just saying, like, Elon Musk is single. I'm single.
Get in there.
You know what I mean? Like,
check Tinder, bro.
Get if you guys see me rolling in a Tesla, you know what's up.
The Cybertruck when we come in for the first live podcast.
Dude, we'd have the sickest studio. Man, I'd
suck
never
see that
him.
Guy's dick, Dylan.
I'd only have to suck his dick once in a while because he's so busy, I'd never see him.
You think he's
Grimes
got a weird
couldn't
name?
Even do that.
Listen, stupid he's bitch. Got like a weird eccentric name for his penis.
Yeah. Oh, it's like AE7X4. It's LV427 or
fucking... what he named his son after.
He probably calls it Blue Origin just to be a dick.
What is it? A something Ash X12?
Oh, yeah, something like that. Yeah. No, he's going to name his dick LV426 from Aliens, dude. It'd be fucking perfect.
Dude.
Make it
sorry for the rant. Elon, if you're listening, what's up, baby?
Get away from her, you bitch!
I want to go to space.
Woo! Neo!
I'm your face sucker. Or I'm your face hugger.
I'll make your chest burst. Neo, fucking from the Discord, sent us this one.
This is Father Bubby.
I need to confess a sin, Father. I worked at a grocery store in my teenage years. I won't get specific. There was this one girl. Are you familiar with the term gumping it?
Father Webby is not familiar with the term gumping it.
So gumping it is when someone is not quite retarded, but they're like just on that line.
They're just on that line.
But they're like just on that line. So while it's an ethical conundrum... It's not fucking a retarded person if you were to sleep with them. This will come important later in the story. She worked in the bakery. And to cut to the chase, because I've already taken a minute of your time, Father.
You're good.
I fucked her ass in the freezer.
God damn it.
Hey, so... Are we far enough into the show that I probably won't get in trouble?
I don't know.
For saying weird things?
Go ahead.
So I met this chick on Tinder like probably like 4 or 5 years ago. And like before we hooked up, she's like, just to let you know, I am autistic. Does that change anything?
And I was now.
I don't know. This just kind of reminded me of it. Like I maybe have done this
thing that you were talking about. You gumped her, dude? Gumper fucker, dude.
Listen, I've had sex with a lot of people. I don't remember all of them, Jay.
At what point of talking about Alan being autistic did it not jump in your head? Go.
I wasn't trying to fuck Alan.
That's not what I'm saying, but I know, the words were brought up, and you don't think with all your Tinder dates going on that when that is being spoke of, you're like, oh yeah,
I'm happy we have that content now, though.
This video was very specific.
I spread my seed. My seed is in the spectrum.
It is very specific, Dylan.
It's Gunther. Very specific to like a situation. I was like my brain just went, you've done this. it all just kind of like you've came to town. So yeah, I like totally met her on like Tinder or something, and then went over to her apartment and had sex on her mattress on the ground, and it wasn't very good.
Checks out.
And then I drove her to her job or something, and then I went to work. It was a weird morning.
Did she bag groceries?
Take her hands away from her ears the whole time.
Did she bag groceries at Safeway, Dylan?
I don't remember where the fuck she worked, but
no. they only hire a certain echelon.
She wasn't like, you know. She was a kid. It was a gumper.
That's the best way I could describe it. I'm sorry.
It was a gumper. It was a gumper. I'm calling it a gumper. I that video, I know what that man's talking about. I've gumped her.
Gump.
I ran for us.
Woo! Let's see. Black Jill from the Discord sent us this one.
It's the Star Wars sequel we never saw coming. The tale of a Queensland woman, a bitter breakup, and at the center of their galactic split, a Wookiee named Chewbacca.
It's Australian news. It is.
A three-year relationship has turned sour. Cairns mum, Jessica, dumping her cheating boyfriend. As payback, he's plastered her phone number around town, advertising a Chewbacca roaring competition, promising a $100 prize for the best one.
The little flyer says Chewbacca roar contest, call blah blah blah.
Something about this seems familiar.
That's a great way to get our podcast fucking phone number voicemail
stuff.
Oh,
go downtown Phoenix?
Do dumb shit like that? Oh, man.
Competition, promising a $100 prize for the best one.
She's playing her voicemails?
Well, I'm getting phone calls at really strange hours of the night, about 1 o'clock till 4 o'clock, hey. I thought it was quite funny, actually. I thought it was a good joke. Just pull it down, please, and yeah, have a laugh for me. And if you want to make a phone call, go for it. I don't mind. Bring it on.
Says he's even dumped his car, tires removed.
He dumped his car off and pulled the tires off of it and parked it in front of her place.
That car, that was a Ford Falcon.
That's, oh yeah. The new Falcon.
What year is that Falcon? I didn't know they made them.
That's like 80s, dude. Jay had like a 50s one.
Yeah, I had a 66.
That is 62.
Yeah, that car took a terrible turn for the worst through the 80s. Look at that thing.
Wow.
It's all coked out on the fucking lawn.
That's Australia. It's Australia.
Look at the one on the lawn, dude. It's like a fucking Suzuki Samurai or something.
That's like Australia's Ford Escort.
This Sheila ain't missing her whole upper deck of teeth, dude. Look at her. Did I use the right term?
I guess. Mind.
Bring it on.
Yeah, dude, she's a...
She could give you a gummer.
She has as much tooth as Rem has chin.
Jessica says he's even dumped his car, tyres removed, in the driveway.
That laugh was perfect.
Luckily, was the force timing. Is strong in the far north.
The police got in contact with me.
Look at the little decal on the side to make it look like it goes fast.
Yeah, it has a little...
That's like those cups.
A little spleen. Man, yeah, this car...
The Jerry cups.
How hard was it to get the jack out from under the car when this thing's sitting on its fucking brakes?
Rotors.
That is impressive that all four tires are off and it's on the ground.
Yep. Yeah, that's like a hard... I just thought of the logistics and it fucked me up.
I want that car.
Your Falcon...
We could probably get you one, dude.
Man.
An old-ass Falcon, like...
Patreon.com /NFHC podcast.
I need $100. There's a Falcon in Australia I want.
You want that one.
Don't they have, like, free health care? They have free tooth care?
Probably they're going to do something about it.
Like, yeah, they just pull them.
And?
Well, they had... This chick had, like... like, 17 appointments.
Yeah. Or one bad one.
Oh, fuck.
I'll take care of these cavities.
And there's a new hope.
Oh, if there's anyone out there that can do the real Chewbacca sound, I might marry you.
Adam Hegarty, Knives.
She saves so much money not brushing her teeth every month, though. Have you ever thought about
that?
A trip to Australia would be cool, though.
Yeah.
Not right now. Right now is a real bad time to go there, but... When shit's cool over there, it'd be cool to go.
So, a lot in this...
At least you can't bite your dick.
The bottom part had a lot of teeth, though, and they were pointy.
Yeah.
Anybody new might be learning this episode, but all the past episodes, Jay's like, oh, bruh, I can't play bass. My thumb doesn't fucking work. I found this guy that just thinks Jay's excuse of not playing because of one thumb missing is bullshit.
Do.
I mean, this guy has unseasoned chicken wings, and he's making this fucking... this. Like, I'm sorry, we went to a great chicken wing place last night, but like...
Fucking Patrick Starfish grew a beard.
This guy is...
gonna fucking knock that shit off, man. That's... that's
good for him.
This guy is just nubbing and winging this fretboard.
They're flat. Definitely flat. Not drums.
How is he?
His timing sucks, though.
He's missing hands and shit. He's missing a bunch of shit, but he's out there trying.
Okay, well, like, most of the time, you're like, whoa, that guy's fucking really good for this. He's, like, still not in time, so fucking next.
Man, I got passion.
I'm just kidding. This is really impressive. Like, I'm joking. That's a joke. This is impressive. Sorry. Fuck, man.
It is, but this is a guy that has to prove that he's not that he's handy capable.
And you're
he's got a bongo, dude.
You're trying, like, to prove
he's
handy.
Never known any... And well, he's never known any other way of playing other than his thumbs. I went to a different world, and now I'm just like, eh, I can play. If I wanted to, I could play the shit out of my bass, or your bass, a bass. But I'm not.
Also, for people who don't know, a Music Man bongo is not a fucking entry-level bass either. That was like an expensive
fucking... That wasn't a bongo, that was just a regular Ernie Ball Stingray. It was definitely not a bongo. That might have been a sub, the low end one. That's
it was paid for with disability checks. Yeah. You fucking privileged cunts.
It's still fucking Ernie Ball. It's expensive.
It's like the Squire version.
Zwick sent us this one.
All right. So over the summer, there was a lot of discourse about showering and which celebrities don't wash their ass or whatever. And one of the things that really seemed to be tripping people up was whether or not people washed their legs.
Well, we had a whole debate. Most people don't, apparently.
And that got me thinking, do you need to wash your legs? And
yes.
So, you know, mm-hmm. I figured I have two legs. That's the perfect amount for a controlled experiment. So for the entire month of September, I only washed...
He's holding his cat the whole time.
So, for the entire month of September, I only washed one of my legs. That's right, only one. One of them did not get washed. Here's a picture of my legs from September 1st, and here is a picture of my legs
from
October 1st. But I figured pictures alone weren't enough. So, I enlisted the help of a few friends to administer the ultimate test. That's right, the sniff test. This is Amanda, this is Monica. Now, before we begin, would Jens tell me if I had a funky leg?
We let you know about
that. I feel like that apartment smells.
Okay. Well, then let's just do this. Let's just get up here. One leg at a time.
Oh, give it a sniff. He's got, like, the Under Armour fucking slides with the worst black sock over. Oh.
Give it a sniff.
His foot situation ain't great.
Okay. Second leg. Do either of you currently have COVID?
No. Mm-mm.
Okay. Can you tell a difference?
No, they both still smell like cigarette smoke and regret.
And there you go. That settles it. You do not need to wash your legs, but I'm still gonna. That shit's weird.
Fucking Seth Rogen really fell off.
Okay. Oh, man. He's...
And, here.
He's dollar store here's Seth Rogen.
Yeah. Here's this. When you wash the rest of your body, soap and shampoo, all that's going to drip down, and you're not going to be able to tell that your leg's
it's
dirty.
It's scenting. It's giving you a nice scent.
A false scent of hope.
Yeah. It's a good episode title.
Oh, wait, hold on. What was it?
A false scent of hope.
That'll work. Yeah, I like that one.
It's the same.
Put it right underneath throat magic.
Because you're like basting your whole body in soapy water. It's like you're fragrancing your skin.
It's like if you put barbecue chicken above a hamburger and all that stuff drips off onto the hamburger, it's going to taste like barbecue chicken, but it's still a hamburger.
Yeah.
Old Man Rogers sent us this one.
Who tells a joke?
Tell you a joke. My dad said, if you ever want to succeed in life, never take no for an answer. He was a terrible dad, but he was a hell of a rapist.
Fuck.
Jesus.
That's the jokes of the Irish right there. God damn it.
Stupid.
It's super stupid. Let's get out on Home Slice sent us this one. It's a cop. Oh, God, take him down rough. So this cop's getting fucked with by like four people, and he just fucking instantly takes one guy down with the knee. This dude's broad comes up to swing on him and instantly tases her, and she just
dropped like Oswald Cobblepot in Batman Returns. Like when he falls down and the penguins carry him into the water.
That's not wrong.
Even the butt.
He looked like he turned around and laughed at his homie. God damn it.
Pull up a picture of the backside of Oswald Cobblepot. Because that's what that was.
Fucking Cobblepot. 100%.
Oh, look at this. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Would y'all look at that?
Tis the spooky month. Thank you everybody that sent that. You can find all the links to send all of that shit to all of our socials over on nfhcpodcast.com. Like to support the show, it's patreon.com/nfhcpodcast. Thank you that everybody that supports it. It really helps it fucking grow and succeed and get us the gear to make the thing better and better every week as we go. We're fucking trying. The next thing we're going to play. What's up? Go ahead, Dylan.
You know how else they can support?
What's that?
The podcast?
What's that?
By going to manscaped.com.
There you go.
And using promo code NFHC.
There you go,
and getting 20% off and free shipping.
There you go, girl.
Because they support the show. Yeah. So support them.
For all your bag needs.
Yeah.
I'm going
to
do that.
I want a community of clean dicks before Christmas. I don't think that's a fucking hard thing to ask. We'll be giving our reviews of it next episode.
Next episode, for sure, we will have fucking ball bags of tone. Yeah.
Get out there and clean your dicks.
The ball tones, bro. We're going to fucking be out there.
Our new album's called White Choney.
God damn it, dude. We do have a What That Dick Do this week.
Let's
get the fucker in there.
All right, it's time to pull back that foreskin and wipe off the schmeg, because we're going to dive down that urethra to see what mistakes you have made. That's right, it's What That Dick Do.
Maddie J, come on, give it to me.
Hey, hey, it's your host, Maddie J. So, I just wanted you all to know that I haven't forgotten about you. As a matter of fact, I've been getting together some phallic fairy tales and seminal stories for this season 4 of the prestigious podcast. However, recently, our super stout host, Matt, brought a serious health problem of cummy caca to my attention.
Oh.
So this week, we are discussing some dick disorders, or some dicksorders, if you will. Number 1, rectal ejaculation. This is described as a case of carcinoma of the prostate causing a fistulous communication between the rectum and prostatic ducts. In other words, pee-pee coming out the poopy hole. And this is not your normal frosted turds that you would get after a long night at the Blue Oyster Club. And if you don't get that reference, watch Police Academy.
Yes!
As I researched this, I found one poor kid who was reaching out via the web for answers. And he wrote, "Hello, I'm an 18-year-old man. I recently met my first girlfriend, and we are not sexually active yet. And whenever I'm with her, I get real horny. And erection, obviously. My testicles start to hurt, and then a couple hours later, I have to go to the bathroom. What looks like semen and smells like semen is discharge from my anus. Is this normal? My testicles usually hurt for 3 to 5 hours after I lose my erection. This has happened past 4 days, and I'm kind of worried." Well, there were a few responses. One helpful hink wrote, "You seem kind of young to have this problem. I have this condition, but from a vasectomy surgery." He goes on to say, "If I come a lot or have intercourse more than 3 times a day, I have symptoms as you describe, diarrhea, gas, and oozing from the rectum with the smell of semen." Well, his advice was to seek a urologist, as were most of the other responses. Meanwhile, poor kid over here is just shitting thick, bleachy loads all over his Charmin 2-ply. Let's just hope he gets it figured out. Next up, Peyronie's disease. No, not pepperonis, Dylan. Peyronie's disease. Now, see, I always thought when a dick had a bend in it, it was just because it was big enough to. Nope.
That's
not always the case. See, the bend happens because of scar tissue.
Oh, no.
From, well, using that. Now, it's not always a problem, but in some extreme cases, you can get what's known as a ram's horn.
Ooh.
Which is essentially your dick making a 90-degree turn in the middle.
Oh.
Eek. But according to doctors, nearly every male will have a curve or bend by time they are elderly.
Huh.
Thank God I'm gonna die long before that. All right, guys. Last one for the night.
Straightest dicks.
Eggplant penis. Yep. That's right. It's not just the emoji you send your stepsister at Thanksgiving. Oh. It's a real thing. Essentially, you zigged when you should have zagged. Pulled out and missed on re-entry. Broke your dick. Well, this is a very treatable and apparently common thing. But if you don't get it checked immediately, boom! scar tissue forms, and now your dick looks like it has taken a fateful left turn in Albuquerque, just like we had talked about them bends up there before.
Oh.
Well, that's all the time I have for this week, but rest assured, I will be back to sing you sweet soliloquies about semen shooters. But until next time, this is Matty J saying, what that do?
The triumphant the triumphant fucking return.
I hope we don't have to wait 18 years for Daddy J to be hanging out more.
No, he's good now.
Okay, good.
He did a lot. He did a lot since he's been
gone. I missed about 10 seconds of that because my internet crashed so hard that I thought that he went boom and my everything just froze and there was no sound. It was fucking crazy. Oh, Home Slice did too? Crazy.
Damn.
I don't know what the fuck happened. That was weird. He weird. Blew up our fucking Discord with a boom through the internet.
Holy
good job.
Shit. Well, I have it all recorded, and I enjoyed all of it flawlessly. Discord hit a reset.
Nice.
So
good timing, Discord.
Boom. Yes, Maddie J, thank you, and congrats on your kid, your broad, your house, your life.
He said he's gonna throw a party soon for us. Ooh, that was, you know what, before we leave, I was thinking that since the house is going to be the house now, we could fucking have Jason Bay feeding you grapes.
Yeah, but everybody's got to go by like 10, dude.
Fuck. Early. Well, no, but my room's above the kitchen now, or whatever, so we're good.
We still have fucking time limits at parties at Dylan's!
No. Anyway. We'll have one that goes to 11, dude.
Alright.
This party goes to 11!
So, thank you, everybody. Welcome to the spooky month and the countdown to season 4.
Beta testing. Open beta. Join the Discord. Say you're new. I'll give you access to the live show on Friday nights until the 4-year episode. And if you like it, you know, maybe you can Patreon up and fucking stay in the live show. It's really kind of like drugs. First one's free.
NFHCpodcast.com 480-788-7330. That's how you get a hold of all of us. But we're out of here for this week. Episode 201 in the books.
We did it.
So grateful to everybody that hangs out every week.
Hell yeah. Just hold on to your fucking seats because we got shit happening.
Oh, there's much more coming.
We're gonna fucking, like, you're gonna recognize us, but you ain't gonna recognize us.
Shit.
Yeah, it's like, you know when, like, you, like, get out of a relationship, and it's been, like, a couple years, and you're, like, feeling good, and then you see them, and they're, like, fucking just fucked off, and you're like, oh, man, yeah. I am the one that won! Fuck you! And then that's what we're gonna be.
Yeah, it's like you're really used to somebody like with long hair forever. Yeah. And then they get a haircut.
Yeah.
On our dicks.
Yeah. Well, no, we're not cutting our dicks.
No, but the hair's on
our
dicks.
That already happened against our will.
It's like moving near Thomas Avenue. Yeah, I get it. Fucking NFHCpodcast.com. We out of here. 201. Thank you, everybody. We're going to get out of here to the band Living Days with the song Thrill Anybody? As a question, so hopefully I said that properly.
Do you want to thrill?
Would you prefer a thrill?
Hey,
yes. Thank you, everybody.
Netflix and thrill, guys?
Netflix and thrill. NFHCpodcast.com. Thank you, Jay. Thank you, Dylan. We out. You're welcome. Everybody. Band Living Days. Thrill anybody.
Netflix and drill. Am I right?
See you next week, everybody.